Tayo ngayon sa Philol Eco Oil Center kung saan magaganap ang opening ceremony ng NCAA Season 99 Women's Volleyball Tournament. At kikilalanin po natin ang mga players ng ating 10 member schools. I am Lizala Nierves for NCAA Season 99. It's official! Last weekend ay official na ngang nagbukas ang Men and Women's Volleyball Tournament ng NCAA Season 99.
Masaya tayo no, na magsisimula na ang NCAA Volleyball Men's and Women's. No? Especially, this is one season away from the centennial celebration. So we're hoping no, na we encourage all the fans, especially yung mga supporters sa mga atleta natin, na supportahan natin ang NCAA. This will be a very exciting season as we are seeing no yung pag-prepare, yung excitement ng lahat ng mga atleta, lalo na ang 10 schools ng NCAA. And we're hoping with your support that we'll be able to achieve no milestones for the NCAA this season.
We are very happy, especially na ang NCAA dito na ginawa sa malaking venue and also with the presence of our boys and girls participation. Na kailangan i-prioritize din nila yung kanilang academics. Kasi sabi nga nila, ang paglalaro is only secondary. Number one is academics. I'm hopeful na matatapos yung liga nito without any kind of injuries na mangyayari sa lahat ng athletes.
Super exciting talaga dahil nagsama-sama na naman in one place ang ating student athletes from our 10 member schools.
Good day, sports fans! This is Game On, the very first sports podcast of GMA. Brought to you by GMA Regional TV and Synergy and GMA DigiLab. My name is Martin Javier.
Half minute left. Shot clock is down to 4. Manalini. Kaboom!
Let's talk about anything and everything about sports. I am Coach Hammer Martin Antonio.
Ang pinaka-key to be a very good shooter, to be able to score, is repetition.
Makasama din natin ang inyong mga iniidolo o paboritong atleta mula rito sa bagong-bagong opisina ng GMA Integrated News. Ako naman po, si Antoine Rojas.
Unang laban sa Seniors Division at grabe, nag-enjoy tayo doon dahil napakainit ng laban ni Borromeo at Canyon.
Game on!
There you go nga po sir. You guys can also find us on GMA News and GMA Sports Facebook page and YouTube channel. You can also find us on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and on Google. All right, very first episode is here. Finally.
Yep. After a long percolating time.
Yeah.
Haba.
Almost a year. Almost a year of waiting.
Finally.
Okay, talagang binuking natin. Matagal tayo naghintay dito. But we're very happy that Game On is finally here on the pod. If you guys don't know, ito po yung extension ng in-between show natin during the NCAA season, volleyball, basketball. We do a mini segment there called Game On. Kinakausap namin yung ibang athletes and we talk about different sports topics. But obviously, we only had limited time. Or on the show, on the TV show, we have limited time.
What was the most shocking transfer to you?
Yung nakita mo last season na pwede ko itong kakampi. Pagkakampi ko ito, champion kami.
Who would win a one-on-one game between you and Jake?
Oh!
bakit ba lumilipat ang mga players? Maraming factor yan. Yan yung susubukan natin pag-usapan at himayin kasama ng ating special guest for today. He is the reigning rookie MVP of NCAA basketball, Mr. Clint Escamis, on this episode of Game On the Podcast.
How's the regulations?
Big number.
How's it going, sports fans? I'm Anton Rojas. Welcome to Game On, the podcast, the first sports podcast of GMA, brought to you by GMA Regional TV and Synergy and GMA Digilab.
We are also seen and heard on GMA News and GMA Sports PH on Facebook and YouTube. Of course, listen to us at Apple, Spotify, and Google Podcast. I am Coach Hammer Martin Antonio.
And my name is Martin Javier. Technically, guys, this is our first episode of the podcast. Kasi yung unang-una natin, that was more of an introduction naming tatlo para, you know, makilala nyo pa kami. Bakit namin papag-usapan ng sports? Bakit kayo maniniwala sa amin? So for today, this is our first episode with a guest. I mentioned earlier, he is the reigning rookie MVP of the NCAA. Last year's comeback king, nandito po Mr. Clint Escamis.
Escamis, welcome back to the NCAA.
Here comes Escamis. Escamis using his speed.
Escamis, oh, his defender falling down. Escamis got deep into the paint.
Escamis breaking free. Escamis for three. Clint Escamis is on fire.
Experiencing a slow start. Here he is. Uncorks and connects from long distance. Clint Escamis.
Today. Escamis, babawi! Clint Escamis with a triple crossover special.
Keep up with non-stop in-court action with GMA Sports. Catch the latest sports news here and round the globe. Be thrilled with conversations about the finest athletes and sports personalities.
Is this it? Yes! Ed Mamuski with a 1-2!
Is now down to just 6.
And never miss a beat on the latest hard court drama. We'll bring you stories behind each point and victory, one play at a time. Follow our official social media handles for your daily fix of hype and adrenaline. Online, GMA Sports!
Another weekend of volleyball, and we are live once again inside the Philoil Eco Oil Center dito po sa lungsod ng San Juan. This is another offering for your NCAA Season 99 Women's Volleyball Tournament, and for our game this afternoon, this should be a good one. Two teams coming off a loss at this point in the season. The EAC Lady Generals still trying to find their first win, going up against a very hungry Mapua Lady Cardinals. Mga kapuso, maraming salamat sa inyong panonood on a beautiful, beautiful Saturday afternoon. You guys can catch everything live stream. Nandyan tayo sa Facebook and YouTube via NCAA Philippines. Nandyan din tayo, mahanap nyo kami on Facebook and X via GMA Sports PH. Hello po sa inyong lahat at syempre live na live tayo ngayon on your television screens on GTV. Martin Abier at your service for today's coverage and working alongside former NCAA player, Rookie of the Year, finals pa po to sa NCAA and pro player as well, Miss Jessica Rakrakin. Welcome, Jessica.
Yes, thank you so much. I'm happy to be here as always. Alam mo, always so nostalgic being back here at San Juan Arena. I'm excited for today's match. Siyempre, magiging maganda tong laban na to, especially since both teams wants to get that win. That's kasi right. Galing sila na pareho sa talo. So, I'm so excited.
At this point, kailangan nakapuhunan na ng panalo yung mga teams natin. So, susubukan nilang dalawang humabol sa ating team standings. Pero ang kukumpleto po, the third man of the broadcast team, or should I say, woman of the broadcast team, nandito po si Stephanie Benito, our courtside reporter, bringing us the stories of both teams. We're very excited, lalong-lalo na. Siyempre, may mga istorya, may mga pinagawa sa ensayo yung mga coaches natin. It's gonna be Stephanie assigned to bring us those details. Pero puntahan ko muna dito si Cheska, EAC versus Mapua as we go to our team standings here. Updated one as well. We see the defending champs and Letran and LPU all undefeated so far. But we find these two teams, Mapua nasa gitna, EAC nasa ibaba.
Yes, so itong position nila sa games today, alam mo, itong win nila very important. So for EAC, ito yung bubuhay pa sa team nila because they will still have a chance pag nanalo sila today. And for the Lady Cardinals, of course, as much as possible, we want to rack up the wins sa early pa lang ng competition and we're almost halfway through. Kaya kailangan nila yung panalo today as well.
That's right, EAC 0-3. Erwan at Hai, San Sebastian at 0-4, Mapua 1-2. This is a Final Four team last season na medyo rocky ang simula sa season 99. Alright, let's go to their previous matchup. Itong EAC Lady Generals, although it was another loss against a surging Letran team, ang kagandahan dito, Cheska, pumalag sila hanggang dulo.
Yes, makikita naman natin na lumamang pa sila sa spikes. Yung service nila, the same lang with Letran. But, ang makikita natin dito sa screen, yung errors na binigay nila sa Letran is 42 errors. Yeah. Very, very crucial. At, sa third set of that match, nakakuha sila ng whopping 17 errors.
Wow.
So, today, ang kailangan nilang focus, less errors, and for sure, kaya nilang mag-go through.
Tama ka doon. Saktong-sakto yan, Cheska. That's been the Achilles heel of EAC this season. Their unforced errors. Again, that's been happening in the past three games for them. Pero, you mentioned the spiking earlier. Mm-hmm. Leading the way was this young lady, Kat Almazan, with 22 points, 19 off spikes, and 3 conversions from the service area.
Wow, I'm so excited to watch kung ano mang mga points ang magagawa niya today. And siya yung leader ng team eh. Yeah. She's a veteran for the Lady Generals. And siya yung inaasahan nila. So I'm excited to see how she plays today.
Kat Almazan, former team captain netong EAC, firing on all cylinders against the Letran Lady Knights. At partidahan natin ha, Letran is very good in marking the star player or the ace of their opponents. So kahit anong iba to sa kanya na blockers, nalulusutan niya.
Yes, very smart player and yun yung mga exciting panoorin because, you know, they don't rely on the power only. Yeah. Talagang ginagamit din nila yung diskarte and yung utak nila sa paglalaro.
Tumuho naman tayo sa kabila. This is the Mapua Lady Cardinals. Their previous result was a loss. It was a 4-set loss against a team that they're very familiar with, itong Perpetua Lady Atas.
Yes, and as you can see sa inyong mga screens, sa Mapua had more spikes, more blocks. But again, yung error na binigay nila sa Perpetual, 32 errors. Yeah. Another crucial error na nagawa nila para makuha pa ng Perpetual yung game na yon.
Pero para dito sa Mapua Lady Cardinals, a bright spot for them is their rookie, one of their promising rookies na si Freyan Garcia. Yeah. All power in that match. 21 points. Just
wow, 21 points for a rookie is so, that's a lot, okay? Yeah. Makikita mo na talagang hindi siya kinakabahan eh. Mm-hmm. Talagang she's confident sa paglalaro niya and she's so excited to be here. Mm-hmm. Na parang walang ka-nerves. Oh, halo talaga lang ng palo.
at andito sa Mapua. Puro rookies lagi yung buwibida sa kanila. Previously, it was Rica Blanca. Ngayon naman si Freyan Garcia. Alright, let's turn you over to our Coliseum announcer dahil pagbalik natin sa number 1 na pakilala na natin yung magsisimula sa magkabilang panic.
Magandang hapon mga kapuso. Mula sa Phil Oil Echo Oil Center San Juan, ito ang NCAA Season 99 New Heroes of the Game. Live ngayon sa GTV Worldwide sa pamamagitan ng GMA Pinoy TV at GMA News TV International at may live streaming pa sa gmanetwork.com, NCAA Philippines website, YouTube and Facebook with NCAA updates, highlights and results on GMA Integrated News. Presenting our officials for this match, first referee, George Suliman. Second referee, Larry Escorial. It's match number 20 in the women's division between the Emilio Aguinaldo College Lady Generals and the Mapua University Lady Cardinals. Let's now meet our starters first from the Emilio Aguinaldo College Lady Generals. Starting it off with opposite hitter number 2, Jen Umapas. Middle blocker number 3, Rhea Magalona. Middle blocker number 5, Jaja Villena. Outside hitter number 7, Crisea Reyes. Outside hitter number 8, Kath Almazan. Setter number 16, George Luke. And our starting libero at number 1, CJ Gorjog. Head coach for the Lady Generals is Mr. Rod Palmero. And now for the side of the Mapua University Lady Cardinals. Kicking it off with opposite hitter number 2, Raiza Rica Blanca. Outside hitter number 4, Freyan Garcia. Middle blocker number 7, Babs Babiera. Setter number 8, Trixie Gohon. Outside hitter number 9, Roxy De La Cruz. Middle blocker number 11, Yana Ong. And our starting libero at number 20, Vanna Basbas. Our head coach for the Lady Cardinals is Mr. Clarence Esteban.
Still the same starters mula sa mga coaches natin, Coach Aling, Coach Rod.
It's the Lady Generals versus, you know,
the same
Lady
starting
Cardinals
unit that they used in their previous game. Para dito sa EAC, they're led by Kat Almazan, who fired 22 points in the previous contest. Sa kabila naman, it's gonna be the rookie combo of Rian Garcia and Raisa Rica Blanca. Kasama mo na dyan si Super Roxy, Roxy De La Cruz. Para sa Lady Cardinals, this should be a good clash this afternoon. Muli, kami po ay nagpapasalamat sa inyong panonood. Live streaming right now, Facebook and YouTube via NCAA Philippines. And YouTube or Facebook and X, and dyan tayo sa GMA Sports PH. Set number 1 is almost here. So first that will be serving is Trixie Gohol. Ito si Trixie. Started also the previous game, pero pinalitan siya midway through. Ito ni Coach Aying Esteban against the University of Perpetual Help. Kaya ang nakarami doon na setting sa kanila, itong si Princess Manarang. Alright, attack error right away. This is what you don't want to see,
yes,
if you are an EAC fan.
Yes, especially since sinabi natin kanina na ito ang naging issue sa previous game nila, yung yeah, errors nila. So, hopefully that doesn't happen again.
Again, an attack error to begin. They gave out, how many, 42 errors in the previous match. Mapuwa rin, 32 naman. So, okay. So, katulad po nung pinakita namin sa inyong stats, ang main problem na magkabilang panic natin ang siyang magbibigay sa kanila ng unang puntos sa isa't isa. Both unforced errors to begin the match here. So, George Lute, she has turned out to be the primary setter neto ni Coach Rod dahil si Ann Formento eh may iniinda pa kaunti na lang na hamstring injury. Jeno Mapas, lefty push. Will not drop. Kat Almazan, gagawa ng paraan. Gohol with the underhand reverse setup. Reyes tries cross court. Is dug up. Back attack. Oh, that's outside. Para dito kay De La Cruz.
De La Cruz overcooking that back row hit.
So both of Papua's points so far coming off an unforced error and an attack error. So, EAC. Again, this is a team na unti-unti, nakukuha na nila yung identity nila. At natututunan na nila, Cheska, na manalo ng mga sets.
Yes, they just need that finisher.
Yeah. Yun na lang talaga ang kulang. Pero ito, kinargahan. If we ever see that, we saw a lot of that against Perpetual.
Garcia targeting cross-court. Diba, medyo delikado pa yun eh. Kasi react siya eh. Pa-outside na, but the libero of the EAC Lady General is picking it up.
Yeah. And she knew it. Alam niya na, medyo malakas yun. Reyes. Garcia is tasked to set this one up to her fellow rookie. That is popped up by Lute. Reyes. And here comes Mapua. De La Cruz. Ooh. Going under that ball. Kaya sumobra.
May gigil yung palo ni De La Cruz. You know, maybe she was trying for a check ball, but that was too high.
Roxy De La Cruz with 16 points against Perpetual. We were expecting her to be the leading scorer talaga nitong Mapua. But so far, it's been Rica Blanca and Frian Garcia na naghalin-hinan to become the top scorer in each game. Kaya tayo. Service error. Ang magdadala sa atin dito, it is Nicole Ong who had 4 blocks. Imagine, against the towers of the Lady Altas. Boom! Off the block. Oh, kill block para sa Mapua.
That was a good block by Babiera.
Oops, Babiera.
You know, ang ganda ng timing niya sa bola eh. Tumalun na yung kanya opposite spiker pero siya nagpalit ng konti.
Oo.
And she got the block.
Parang nabasa niya na magko-cross court itong si Almazan. Omapas from the back. Oh, it catches the line.
Good target by Omapas. Getting that line in zone 6.
Coach Rod told me, itong si Jen Omapas. Yung isa sa mga inaasahan niya this season. Kasi sarang ganda daw ng performance dun sa kanilang mga off-season tournaments. Pero obviously, Jess, iba talaga yung intensity kapag ka Mother League na, yung NCAA na, no?
Yes, kasi may pride na eh. Isang account na na-account mo na yung pride sa games dito. And of course, yung atmosphere and yung pressure from your school then.
That's right. So, lahat na yun, combined na yun. So, it adds up to the player's pressure. But speaking of pressure, Katja Villena, calm and composed at the service line, scoring an ace. EAC pulls ahead. 5-4. Encouraging start for the White Shirts. Oh, quick attack. Mula kay Babs Babiera.
Good target by Babiera. Targeting yung middle attacker din. Na nasa likod of the Lady Generals. Alam mo, medyo meron tayong conception na medyo mahina ang rumisive at dumipensa ang mga middle blockers. So that was a good target for her.
Ooh, okay. Kasi nga, as we see this error on Mapua's side, let's check out what happened first. Lumawak ba? Okay. Always a point, nonetheless, for EAC. But you're right, ano? Bihira. Siyempre, pag matangkad, mas mahirap talagang dumipensa.
You need to reach the floor, eh. Kasi yun ang laging pinapaalala ng coaches.
That's right.
Bumaba kayo, bumaba kayo, bumaba kayo. Wow!
Ang Bazan. Wow, early production here in the opening set for Kat. She's been getting her way so far.
Far, cross-court, getting that line. Uh-huh. Alam mo, tinignan na lang ng libero eh, because she was medyo naka-abante siya. So, hinabaan ni Almazan yung palo niya and the libero couldn't get to it.
Oof! Jump serve from Jen Omapas goes straight to the net. So, ito si Perses was also utilized by Coach Aying against Perpetual. Pumasok na kanina, pinalitan si De La Cruz. So, Roxy will head to the bench first. Almazan with a combination play. And we head to our first technical timeout with EAC in front. But how about this emphatic hit? She is rolling here in set number one at Almazan. Pagbalik natin, let's hear a report from Stephanie Benito.
Basketball junkie ako eh. So, Jowo, Coach Jolie pa. Mm-hmm. Yung mga yan, yung mga old school, kasi yan yung mga nakalakihan ko na dream. So medyo lumalabas na yung part ako of that older generation eh, who believe that.
Hindi kayo yung generation.
Hindi mo na generation, but kayo TikTok generation.
Wow!
Kasama na kita. Kasi yun yung conversation natin kanina. Ako, Jaworski tsaka Jolie pa yung... but again.
You're watching the NCAA Season 99 Women's Volleyball Tournament. This season has not been smooth sailing so far for both teams as the Mapua Lady Cardinals are still trying to bounce back from their losses while the EAC Lady Generals are still trying to look for their first win. Kaya nga para sa coach ng Lady Cardinals si Coach Aying Esteban, maturity daw ang napapansin niyang rason kung bakit nahihirapan silang makasungkit ng panalo. Hilaw pa daw kasi ang kanyang mga manlalaro dahil karamihan nga ay mga rookies pa. So to combat this, Coach Aying reminded his team to be good decision makers inside the court and to play productively, rookie ka man o veteran. Para naman kay Coach Rod Palmero ng Lady Generals, confidence at self-discipline naman ang nakikita niyang rason sa mga heartbreaking losses. Kaya naman more than just their physical health, ay mas nag-focus daw ang coaching staff and helping them mentally by motivating the team coming into this game. Gaya nga nung nakasulat sa board sa loob ng dugout ng Lady Generals na lagi ding paalala ni Coach Rod, enjoy, trust yourself, and trust each other. That's their key to winning today. Ito muna sa ngayon sa magkabilang panig, Martin and Cheska.
Thank you so much, Stephanie. That's a great report on our coaches and what they had to say about the performance of their respective teams. Pero unahin ko muna yung kay Coach Rod, confidence and discipline, lalong-lalo na sa mga dulo ng set pag kailangan na nilang tumapos.
Yes. Alam mo, malaking factor kasi yung mental health sa paglalaro eh. You can be prepared physically, pero pag yung mentally hindi ka makasunod, yung kinakabahan ka, sige, alam mo yun, sinasize up mo na agad na mas malakas yung kalaban mo sa inyo. Yeah. You know, it's a big deal para sa mga players na talagang magte-tense up ka eh habang naglalaro eh. Okay. So, maganda yung sinabi ni Coach na, you know, they need to be more confident in the way they play kasi nag-training naman silang lahat eh. Mm-hmm. Pare-pareho sila nag-training.
Sabi rin sa akin ni Coach Rod, as we see this wing from Raisa Rica Blanca, sa practice naman daw, maganda galawan. Grabe yung intensity sa game itself na talaga. When, you know, you face the bright lights, you know, it's televised. So, dagdag-nagdag yung pressure. Kaya medyo talagang, yun, you mentioned, nagiging tense yung galawan ng mga players. Para naman kay Coach Aying Esteban, you know, this is a team that made it to the Final Four a season ago. And a lot is expected for them in season 99. So if you are a rookie, tama siya, kahit rookie, kahit veteran, kailangan mo mag-perform. If you're a rookie, you need to grow up quickly. Diba? You don't have time to, you know, to take a few games and work on your maturity. Kailangan mabilis yung growth mo.
Yes, kasi that's what the preseason leagues are for. Yeah. Diba?
That's true. Yeah.
But ang gusto ko lang kasi sinabi ni Coach Aying is, you know, kailangan nilang mag-isip. You just need to think. And that's a good advice for me. Kasi palaging nire-reason yan eh. Kapag wala kang game, you know, they say na, ay, rookie kasi, rookie team kasi sila. But, you know, pagka nag-iisip kasi yung mga players, it doesn't matter kung rookie ka or not. If you're thinking, makakagalaw ka ng maayos eh.
That's right. By the way, at this point, kanina, abante pa ang EAC. Ngayon, mapuwa na, courtesy of a 4-0 flurry from the Lady Cardinals. Ay, balik. Itong Lady Generals dito, ang isang puntos doon. So, George Lute to serve. Things quickly changing here in the opening set.
Yeah.
Because early on, it was all in favor of EAC. Ngayon, pagkatapos ng technical timeout, pinis ng bawi ng Mapua. 2 points for Nicole Ong.
Power tip from Nicole Ong, targeting yung center side. Kasi alam mo, magandang target din yan. Because if the center picks up the ball first, wala nang set. Diba?
Oh.
They throw it to open na lang.
Yeah. It's gonna be an easier take kung maitatawid man nila.
That's right.
So 12-10, Rian Garcia. Lute, Reyes, guiding it left, but it was wide.
Yeah, you can see na iniwasan niya talaga yung blocker. Kaya yung pag-sway niya dun sa bola, talagang diretso palabas eh.
Oh. Ito actually si Chris Reyes, isa sa mga ina-expect natin mag-emerge for EAC. Because when it comes to firepower, alas pare sila ng kalibre ni Almazan eh. Oh, Ong. Strong tip, isa pa mula kay Nicole Ong. Oh, mapas. That one was deflected. Trixie Gohol to Berses. Oh, kept alive. What an effort from De Andres. Pero may save din dito si Garcia. Rica Blanca. Drop. Pasambasa ni Umapas. Villana with a lefty push. Sarado. Sabi ni Nicole Ong. Reyes. Rally continues. Longest one so far. Ooh. De Andres with a good dig again. Back attack. Not gonna work, says Garcia. Ong, ooh, that was low from Nicole Ong.
Medyo talagang mababa eh. She tried to get it across, pero talagang mababa yung binay ng bola.
Longest rally so far in the match. Both teams showing us solid floor defense and net defense na rin. Frazier Reyes to serve. Gohol. Backs it for Rica Blanca. Mapua retaliates quickly here.
That was a good spike by Rica Blanca. The libero of the Lady Generals. Inuulang siya doon eh. Kasi paatras pa si Deandres. But she dug the ball up habang paatras pa siya. So wala siyang solid control doon sa bola.
Malakas pa naman. Uy! That's an ace! For Nicole Ong, iniwasan ng EAC. They thought it was going long.
Deandres attempted.
Yeah.
Kaya hindi na kinuha ni Reyes.
Oh. Ganda yung targeting din ni Nicole Ong doon. Here's the first pass. Umapas down the line. Andoon si Ong. Over to Rica Blanca. We had to adjust because that was too near the net.
Na-off yung kanyang approach. But you know, ayun yung mga sinasabi ni Gordy, ayun yung mga moments na pwede nilang gamitin yung smarts.
Oo.
You know, yeah. If you can't, hindi mo na mapapalo, you can just, you know, gagawin mo na lang siya na paraan talaga eh. Just to get it across. Kasi sa volleyball, a point is a point. Kapag nag-error ka, point na ng kalaban. So, mas okay na lang to keep it alive.
That's right. And it's, well, as an attacker, lefty attacker, it's always tricky.
Yes.
Diba? Kapag kaaliwete siya. Lalo yung set sa setter din, tricky rin yung mga sets niya, diba? Iba kasi yung discarte dyan.
Yes. That would have been easier for a right-handed spiker.
Oh, correct, correct. Here's Almazan, who repositioned for that attack. Back row hit. Oh, it is denied.
Wow.
Magalona.
She had a good read on that back row attack. Talagang kitang-kita mo, diretso sa kamay niya yung bola eh.
Bam! The denial single block nito ni Magalona. You like the reaction afterwards. Grabe yung sigaw niya doon. 13-15. Captain of VAC this year, itong si Galliardas. Bam! Better attack from Rica Blanca. Omapas. Underhand setup over to the other side. Berses pushing it through.
Yes, that was off the block for Berses.
Second technical timeout. It is Mapua in front by 3.
Coach Hammer versus Madza.
Much respect. Totally dominant player.
Facts. Facts. Yeah. Thank you so much to everybody who tuned in. Patikim pa lang po ito. We are so excited for what's to come. Game On Podcast with me, Martin, and Coach Hammer. Thank you so much sa lahat ng mga nanood. Reminder though, NCAA Season 99 Volleyball Tournament
with our ultimate analyst.
My name is Anton Ross.
NCAA Season 99 on GTV, the Women's Volleyball Tournament. Dr. Lorenzo Lorenzo, Mancom representative from EAC. Ang masayang nanonood dito. Thank you for watching us. My live stream as well, NCAA Philippines at GMA Sports PH. And Sir Melchor Davina, wala naman sa Mapua University. And Sir Melchor, sanay kumaway eh. Diba?
Yeah.
Steady lang. 16-13, it is Mapua ahead by 3, fully recovering dito sa ating opening set. At ito na, si Princess Manarang, secondary setter, papalitan si Trixie Gohol. That's Berses was the one who scored right before our technical timeout. That's a rookie from Angeles, Pampanga, itong si Nadine Berses. Almazan. Back row approach, ultimately falling short.
Yes. Reyes trying to just get the ball across. Ginagawa niya na lang ng paraan. Pero kinulag yung power sa top spin.
Yeah, binukuha niya doon. So Manarang. Oh! That one. Kung may point yung pagtama sa antena yung mag-target, utos yun. Pero siyempre lang outside yun. Anformento coming in for the first time. Ito yung backup setter ni Coach Rod Palmero. Razonable also coming in. Doble palet para kay Coach Rod. So Omapas and Lute going out. It's Formento and Razonable in. Oh! Mapua with the rotation error.
Na magawa ng team.
Libre. Tapos, kakaserve pa lang. Oh. Hindi pa nagsisimula yung rally.
Yes, and also, sa training pa lang, alam niyo na yung position niyo lahat.
Oh, this is a better pickup for Mapua. Berses, na-check na. Te Guzman. Razonable. Tries here. Nothing there. Manarang. Choosing Te Guzman again. Binuhay ni Reyes. Almazan, Abuelo. Cross-court kill for Kat Almazan.
And I love the celebration after that hit. You know, powerful hit from Almazan, cross-court. And that was from a loose ball.
Yeah.
Talagang galing na sa likod. Makikita mo kung gaano siya kagaling mag-adjust sa bola.
Baklasin Kat Almazan yung nakikita natin this season. Much better scorer. Mapapower o diskarte. Really improving. Berses! Yes! How about that, Berses? I call her the nonchalant spiker of Mapua.
Yeah, you can see no reaction after that hit.
Ganda ng mga cross-court niya dun. Pero relax. Yung teammates pa niya yung mas hyped up.
Yeah, she's deadpan lang eh, no?
Oh, she serves now. Almazan! Wow! Ooh. Bumalik ang bola. Push by Razonable. It is sent back by Garcia.
Yeah. Razonable fumbling that ball. Kasi binigay niya ng easy drop ball. Binalik sa kanya ng heavy block.
Yeah.
And she needs to step up silang dalawa ni Formento because ito yung mga substitution na kailangan para may blocker sa harap eh. Yeah. Para may attacker, three spikers pa rin sa harap. So,
I think nabibigyan ng chance ang EAC.
Yes.
It is another error on the side of Mapua. Let's check this one out. Babs Papiera called for this one. We'll see if she touched the net.
That was over-received.
Over-received pala, hindi pala net touch.
And dahil po back row ang setter ng Mapua, bawal silang mag-over ng bola above the net.
Peses. Targeting Cordial. Almazan.
Oof.
Oh, it's outside.
That was wide for Almazan. Pero that was a good target because walang tao doon.
Yeah. So you can tell she reads the defense first before she attempts. Pops Baviera, the veterans of this Mapua team. Been here in the league for a while now. Maybe 3 seasons already for Babs. Razonable off the block.
That was a good attack by Razonable using her blockers to get that point.
So EAC keeps it close. Ito sa ating opening set. Nagbabalik para sa Lady Generals. Itong si Jaja Villana replacing their captain, Ada Gallardes.
Yes. Yung namang substitution na yun is for the defense naman sa back row.
Ah, okay.
Para andun yung libero, and then yun, nandun din yung captain nila na madepensa. Oof!
Nagtinginan lang dun yung EAC. Nicole Ong scores on the slight push. Check out natin dun.
There were 2 people there.
Yeah.
Pero walang nag-pick up ng bola.
Walang nag-mine. Okay, Coach Rod.
Wala silang ginagawang mahirap eh. Kayo ang nagpapahirap dun sa galaw. Hindi sila. Hindi nyo nasi-secure kasi imbis na kayo yung mag-secure nung galaw nyo, hindi nyo sinisecure. Ah, kung gusto natin, ano, huwag tayo mataranta. Wala. Wala namang malakas. Ha? Nababasa niya pero ayaw niyong gumalaw. Nababasa niya, Eric, sabi sa inyo, namin natin hero.
Coach Rod.
Yeah, he's reminding his girls na yung errors i-lesson nila. And sila lang nagpapahirap sa galaw nila because andun na, nabasa na nila yung mga play ng Mapua. Pero hindi sila kumukuha ng bola. You know? Andun na sila sa position, pero wala. Wala kumukuha ng bola.
Ang words niya, hindi niya sinisecure yung galaw niya. Yan. Again, in volleyball, you gotta be sure with your movements. You gotta be fully committed.
Yes, and walang yours sa volleyball. It's always mine.
Yan. Wow.
Mas okay na nag-aagawan kayo sa bola, pero kesa dun sa walang kukuha ng bola.
That's right. Garcia gets that point.
Yes.
Roxy De La Cruz on her screens. Yeah, she is on the bench right now. She was substituted out of the game early on, and Roxy, she's hiding, I think.
Yeah, too much emotion there.
Yeah, showing us the emotions here. Of course, as one of the main gunners of this team, you want this opportunity
to help your team.
To help your team, exactly. But so far, her team is doing well. A kill block once again for the Lady Cardinals.
That was Ong once again.
Ganado si Nicole Ong. Just a force at the middle. Bihira yung nakakalusot dito kay Nicole Ong.
Ha? Oh, tama ba yan? Namigay kayong 21 points? Ha? Hindi nyo kasi sinisecure eh. Ang pairali natin, yung tapang ng isip natin, hindi yung hila ng dibdib natin. Natatakot tayo magkamali, masyado nating sinisecure yung sarili natin, hindi natin secure yung galaw natin. Ha? Paikuti mo nilang ang isa.
Alright. Yeah, you guys are seeing Roxy De La Cruz. Again, still very emotional on the bench of Mapua. Tama ba yung sinabi ni Coach Ron? Mabuha only has 23 points. 21 errors daw sabi ni Coach Ron Palmer. Pero for sure it's less than that. You know, he's just trying to wake up this team. Kasi ganito na naman, nakakadikit dahil sa simula hanggang gitna, pagdating sa dulo, bumibitaw.
Yes, it's their errors na nagiging crucial for them.
So 23-18. By the way, Trixie Gohol is back in for Mapua. Underhand reverse set. Saved by Berces. Garcia! Powerful down the line hit.
Garcia! Bring your whole family into that spike. Hindi kinahayan ang defense eh.
Buong angkan. Kargado doon sa spike na yun as we see Roxy De La Cruz. Set point for Mapua. Oh! Okay. That's a breather for EAC. So that enables them to stay here and stay alive rather here in set number one. Lute and Omapas will be checking in. Balik si Coach Rod sa kanyang mga starters dito.
Yes. Again, gusto kasi ni Coach na always merong three attackers and three tall blockers sa harapan.
Lute. Good serve. Garcia. No answers from EAC side para dito kay Priyan Garcia.
Yes. That was a great target for her. Target in zone 6. Walang katao-tao.
The rookie leading the Lady Cardinals in that set number 1. They win it 25-19 and they take the 1-7 lead. Pagbalik po natin, we'll proceed to the highlight stats and the second set of this match.
Mga kapuso, let's take a quick look back at the early goings of our brand new NCAA volleyball tournament here in the first edition of our Week in Review. On opening day last Sunday, the Benilde Lady Blazers began their quest for a three-peat on a high note as they dominated EAC 25-15, 25-14, 25-23. Graduating middle blocker Mitch Gamit led the way for the Taft Avenue-based squad with 10 markers. In the match that followed, Perpetual flexed their muscles against JRU, winning 25-14, 25-14, 25-21. Reigning league MVP Mary Rose Dapol top scored for the Lady Altas with 16 points. On Tuesday, Mapua outclassed San Sebastian with a 25-20, 25-23, 25-18 victory. Sophomore Super Roxy De La Cruz exploded for 18 points.
This is still the NCAA Season 99 Women's Volleyball Tournament. Set number 1, panalo po ang Mapua Lady Cardinals contra EAC. They take the 1-7 lead. Final was 25-19. Martin Javier Chess karakrakin in this broadcast. And it was Mapua who was able to finish that set well. Cheska.
Yes, alam mo, naging factor doon yung mga errors nitong Lady Generals. But, gumawa rin talaga ng puntos ang Lady Cardinals.
Yeah. Iba-iba ang pinanggalingan ng puntos. But mostly, nanggaling dito sa kanilang player of the game against Perpetual na si Frian Garcia. Again, picking up from where she left off against the Lady Altas. Papunta dito sa Lady Generals, scoring a bunch of points. And even Nicole Ong was actually solid, especially with her net defense. Ito yung numbers natin, Chess.
Yes, you can see na talagang sa attacks, talagang nanguna ang Lady Cardinals with 13 against Lady Generals 7. Sa blocks, si Nicole Ong nanguna for 3 blocks. And patay lang sila ng aces, but, you know, Mapua gave more errors. 10 errors against the Lady Generals 8 errors.
Pero talaga nagkatalo lang sa firepower.
Yes.
In terms of spiking, doon lang tayo nagkaroon ng pinakamalaking diferensya. Of course, EAC relied heavily on Kath Almazan, pero siya lang.
Yes.
Right, yes.
Alam mo, si Almazan kasi she knows yung talagang yung blockers kung saan pwesto. Alam mo, mautak siya and she has the firepower, which is great.
Sweet Makatangay in attendance. Former player ng Mapua, parehas yan indoor and beach volleyball. course, anak ng ni Miss Cherry Makatangay, former national team player natin. Also participated in 1991 the Southeast Asian Games during her time. All right.
Second set
is here. It is EAC versus Mapua again. If you guys just tuned in, Mapua is at 1-2, coming off a loss against Perpetual. EAC 0-3, fresh off a loss versus Letran. And we start with another powerful strike from Garcia.
Alam mo, lakas ng palo ni Garcia, but you can see she has a very sweet smile afterwards.
Don't be deceived.
Yeah, walang kayabang-yabang.
Kargado na talaga pumalo. Yeah. And again, si Frian, hanggat hindi mo na didepensahan yung mga powerful hits niya, hindi pa yan mag-a-adjust. Puro power ay bibigay niya sa'yo.
Yes, because why change what works, di ba?
Exactly. And it's another one for her. She is on fire so far in the match. This time, she gets a kill block.
You know, we all love an all-around player. Malakas pumalo, marunong bumlak, magaling mag-serve. May depensa pa.
May depensa. Ooh. Exactly.
That was a net touch by Ong.
Okay. Net touch. So Lady Cardinals will give the first point of VAC.
Yes. Alam mo, isa't kasi kapag nag-bumlak ka, nagigigil ka ng konti, tumidikit talaga eh.
Rin din yung problema ng Mapua. 32 errors against Perpetual. That really hurt them, especially in critical junctures of the game. Yes. Nats versus Almazan mula sa likod. Versus with a dig. Oh, Nico Long. But that one was deflected. Almazan denied. Formento guiding it to Omapas, who scores through the block.
Mapas using her blocker. Well, yun yung bawi niya daw from kanina eh. You can see talaga sa gitna ng kamay ni Garcia dumaan yung bola.
Shoot na shoot. Yeah. Nabawian ni Umapas si Garcia. But she's always had the power. Mm-hmm. Ang kailangan pa niya i-polish yung kanyang diskarte. Rica Blanca. Ooh. Oh! That one hit the net. Digneto ni Jaja Villena.
Villena was there. Kanyang-kanya na yung ball eh. But mali yung control. Mali yung... See? No control over the ball. Yeah, yeah. That's why it went straight to the net.
It was Rica Blanca who scored that for Mento. Omapas! Oh, that's the power I was talking about earlier. We'll see if there's a check. Yeah. No check.
That was too long. Mataas yung ball eh. There's no check. And we can see naman pag may check.
Mag-iiba talaga yung trajectory.
Yeah.
Garcia. It's a good serve. Almazan there. Swings away.
Yeah, you can see there. May check.
Malina. Kat Almazan continues to score against these Mapua blockers.
Using the blocker's hands to get that point.
Again, for EAC, siya lang so far. Ang pinaka-effective at efficient. Jaja Villena to start. Difficult first ball. Pero bubuhayan at itatawid. EAC has a chance. Almazan. Napasa ni Gohol. Rica Blanca.
Yeah.
The block went to the antenna. So that's a point for Raisa Rica Blanca.
Rica Blanca. You know, parang pinadaan niya lang sa kamay ni Almazan eh.
Ay, sa Rica Blanca, by the way, 20 points a couple of games ago. So, meron ka ng Rica Blanca, may Garcia ka pa. Tapos, may sumusuport pa na. Versus ngayon, emerging as well for the Lady Cardinals.
Mo errors nang talaga ang pamatay.
Kita mo naman yung fold na yun ni Rica Blanca. Although it is popped up. Gohol. Inabot. Wow. Babs Babiera puts it down.
Babiera with a tip.
How about this? It's Gohol who tracked it down.
Alam mo, medyo dinaanan na si Babiera nung set eh. Napunta na sa kanyang left side but she twisted and just tipped the ball.
Making up for the delay. yung mata, yung adjustment yeah. doon ni Babs. Oh! What a dig by Garcia. Perses. Oh. Yeah. Medyo nahirapan siyang kunin yun.
Oo eh. Naka-forward na siya. Nag-start na siya ng approach niya. But the ball, yung set, pupunta sa likod niya. So she had to adjust.
So Razonable comes in for EAC. She comes in for the struggling Krisia Reyes na hindi pa nakukuha yung rhythm dito sa laban natin. 4-6. Jenu Mapas, here's the jump serve. The hold, back set, Rica Blanca sends it away.
Wow!
The lefty killer goes down the line.
That was late blocker. And para sa kanya, that was breakfast. Oh, alam mo yun?
Correct.
Ah, wala akong blocker or late yung blocker ko. That's gonna be so easy for me.
Matik, down the line ng decision.
Yeah.
Razonable. Rica Blanca over to Verses this time.
Oh,
that one was sent back. Yeah. Sabi nila, good pa. Fermento. Razonable from the back. Ah, oh, dug up. Oh, what a play. Itatawid din. Long rally. Perses!
Wow!
The rookie Nets Perses sends us to our first technical timeout. Stephanie Benito will be bringing her report afterwards.
What was the most shocking transfer to you?
Yung nakita mo last season na pwede ko itong kakampi. Pagkakampi ko ito, champion kami.
Who would win a one-on-one game between you and Jake?
Oh! Bakit ba lumilipat ang mga players? Maraming factor yan. Yan yung susubukan natin pag-usapan at himayin kasama ng ating special guest for today. He is the reigning rookie MVP of NCAA basketball, Mr. Clint Escamis, on this episode of Game On the Podcast.
In the name of Kat Almazan of the EAC Lady Generals and Fion Garcia of the Mapua Lady Cardinals na parehas nagpakitang gilas sa kanilang mga laro noong nakaraan. Para kay Kat, huling season na ang maglalaro para sa Lady Generals. Setting a good example to her teammates is what drives her to play her best every game. Bagay na nakikita pa rin natin na ginagawa niya para sa araw na ito kahit na medyo nahihirapan ang koponan. Ang sabi naman sa akin ni Fion, yung tiwala daw sa kanya ni Coach Ying at ng kanyang mga teammates ang naging dahilan kung bakit maganda ang nilalaro niya recently. Something that she wants to keep. Quick reminder lang from Coach Ying para sa set na ito, masyado daw sila lang nag-iingat sa kilos nila na in return ay nawawala na sa tempo at wala na sa timing. And though he commended his team for winning the first set, he wants to see more. Isa na nga sa sinabi niya ay mag-communicate daw ang team para sa set na ito sa loob ng court. Ito muna sa ngayon, balik sa inyo.
Maraming salamat, Stephanie. We're talking about Almazan and Frian Garcia, a veteran on her last year in the NCAA against a first-year player, Rhea Magalona, converting there. We talk about Kat Almazan and how much she's improved, even, you know, if her team or when if her team is struggling during the NCAA.
You know, she's just leading by example.
Yeah.
Kasi she's the veteran of the group. And kailangan niyang pakita na, you know, ako gumagalaw ko ng maayos. So you can either step up and follow me or paano tayo mananalo
correct.
If it's just me.
Leading exactly by example si Kat Almazan. Back to her old jersey, by the way. Ito yung kanyang jersey number 8. Jersey number nung kanyang freshman season.
Maybe that was our lucky number.
Lucky number. Tapos naging 13 siya in the past few years and now she's back to 8. Before she exits EAC.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, dito naman sa Mapua Frian Garcia, grabe yung kumpiyansa na ibinibigay sa kanya ng kanya mga kakampi. Why not? Ang lakas siya pumalo eh.
Yeah.
Okay, ito siya. Speaking of.
Oh,
yun. Nasobrahan lang.
Yeah. Napalakas masyado. Nabate. But, you know, for a rookie to be playing in our caliber,
yeah.
You can see kung bakit siya yung pagkakatiwalaan ng team.
And this much confidence, ano? Siyempre, galing na rin yan sa tiwala ni Coach Aying Esteban.
Yes. Alam mo, yung tiwala ng coach, napakamalaking bagay niyan.
Lalo sa moral
ng
mga players.
Because you know, your coach knows you the best. Yeah. Kung paano ka maglaro.
That's right. Back row hit versus who's been providing quality minutes here for Mapua. Rebustes giving it to Garcia this time.
Wow. That was a powerful hit na hindi kinaya ni Villena. And it just went through her. Look at that.
Only one mission for Freya Garcia. Yeah. Each time she gets the ball, kakagahan ko to.
One blocker is not enough.
Exactly. Ang hilap igilan. Babs Babiera starts it up. Abuelo si Razonable. Pinuhay. Tumawid! It's alive.
No.
Razonable. Uy.
You know, na-miss nila yung pag-count ng bola.
It's just awareness.
Yeah.
Awareness from the AC side.
And yes. You know, the first ball was from Fermento. And then another person popped it up. And then she sent it again. Na dapat in-over niya na yung bola.
Sabi ko sa inyo, sugal niyo na yung serve, pwede ba? Sugal niyo na yung serve. Lagyan natin ng speed. Pwede? Naiintindihan niyo pa ba ako? O, natataranta ka. Kailangan ko yung gumawa kayo doon sa sinasabi ko. Yung in-scout niyo, gawin niyo.
Sabi ni Coach Rod, of course, Kat Almazan also echoing the statements of Coach Rod as we see Coach Aying Esteban here. Sabi ni Kat, mawawalan na tayo ng enjoyment. Nung kanina nung simula nung timeout natin. Parang may nagtatranslate. Ibang lingwa.
Akala ko nagja-Japanese si Coach.
Si Coach Aying, ano?
Yeah.
Boses ni Coach Rod.
Alam mo, malaking bagay talaga yung enjoyment sa paglalaro.
Yeah.
Because kapag wala na yan, puro nerves na lang ang umiikot. Sobrang tense nyo nang gumalaw. Everything you do, kahit yung pag-re-receive lang, it's gonna be harder. And mas madali mag-commit ng error.
Yes. Talaga nag-freeze ka.
Yes, and yung pag-iisip mo, foggy.
Correct.
You can't think. So yeah, they need to relax. Absolutely.
Gaano ka-importante ang decision making sa volleyball. Gohol. Tony Gohol on. It is saved. Razonable. Una doon si Rica Blanca. Isa pa. Regalo. Ay pagsabayan si Gohol. Garcia will try. Easy up for EAC Villena with a push. Ow. Sent back by Nicole Long. She is...
No coverage.
Yeah. She's got tremendous timing talking about Nicole Ong. Bang klase ang timing na to. Kaya kahit single block, si Nicole lang ang naiwan doon. Kumpiyansa ka na at least madedeflect yung bola.
And yung mga spiker as well, iniiwasan siya eh.
Oh, correct. Oh! Ito mo, binuhay pa niya to. Good reflexes by Ong. Chance though for EAC. Dulak! Check out for Razonable.
Wow! Razonable just tipping the ball through the hands of her blockers. Kasi medyo na-late na siya dun eh. But, ginawa niya na lang ng paraan. And you can see na talagang kahit saan siya ilagay, no? Naglalaro lang si Razonable. Yeah. Kanina, she was in the opposite position and now she's an open spiker. No problem.
Grabe yung mapakita ng versatility itong si Razonable. Not on the service line in that instance, though.
Masyado,
40-8.
Yeah, masyado ko na daw siyang nababate.
Na-hype mo daw. That's a good time for EAC, though. At least nakakita na sila na pupwedeng tumulong kay Almazan.
Yes.
Frian Garcia. Oh. That's a faulty first ball. Here's a chance. Perses! Tignan nga natin, hindi pa rin.
Wala pa rin reaction.
Nonchalant pa rin itong si Nance Perses.
Yes. Nonchalant or OA lang yan. Siya daw si Nonchalant.
Siya si Nonchalant. Tignan mo, wala talaga. No reacts from Nance Perses. Laro lang. Frian Garcia. Oh, service ace.
Wow.
From Garcia.
Yes.
16
Garcia again.
Yeah, it's her again from the service line. Let's go to our second technical timeout. Apua doubling up on EAC.
Ito, sa Game On Podcast, we can absolutely talk about anything. We can have lengthy conversations, meatier conversations.
Palitan and mas maraming chikan.
That's right. And I think it's only right because, I mean, first of all, special thanks goes out to everybody who tunes in and watches the show. We have been fortunate enough to have been recognized by Trinity, by Anak TV. So I think it's only...
Back to live action. Dito po sa loob ng Philoil Eco Oil Center in San Juan City, it is the Mapua Lady Cardinals with a commanding lead here in the second set. Kasama niyo, Cheska Rakrakin. Martin Javier, love the photo. Diba? Ito na yung naging photo natin ngayon for you guys to have a visual of
kung
the ones
po
talking. Sino nga ba? Sino itong mga ito? Diba? Thank you for joining us. Stephanie Benito also here as our courtside reporter reporting for both teams. 16-8, it has been all Mapua dito sa second set natin.
Medyo malayo na yung lamang ng Mapua University. And ito yung mga positions sa game na you don't want to be in.
Yeah.
Maghahabol ka ng 8 and that's a large number.
Correct. Versus large part of the equation for Mapua. Aurica Blanca. Adjusting underhand set up for Almazan, denied. Ong stays resilient, pero buhay pa. Umapas
wow.
Scores.
Umapas getting that point for the Lady Generals. Nakita mo yung hustle doon ni Almazan, nablock pa siya, siya pa rin yung kumuha ng bola. And you gotta respect that.
Oh, kung ikaw yung teammate niya, may inspire ka talaga na tagasipagan mo rin. Being effort. Ada Gallardes, team captain of EAC. Papasok para sa serve. Papalitan si Jaja Villena.
Yes, ang kanilang service specialist.
So, the Lady Generals will try to chip away.
Ooh. Mm-hmm.
And that's not what you want to see if your coach Rod, your service specialist, committing a service error.
Yes.
17. Tonight is the tally. Nicole Ong, one of the best middle blockers in the league. Still, from her first year up to now, isa pa rin po siya sa pinakamagagaling.
Yeah. And she's just a sophomore.
Yeah.
Diba?
Oh, not third year.
Third year?
Yeah.
Okay.
She came...
Second season. Sa volleyball.
Oh. Well done. Back set. Loot. Oh. That's a good attack. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Nicole Ong was here season 97 in Paco Arena. She was there. And then 98, third season.
Oh, yeah.
I will check. Don't worry.
Yeah, that was a short season. Kasi.
That was a short season, yeah. Let me check.
What?
I'll check it for you.
She's baby face naman. So, acceptable na yan. Sige.
Pero mahirap yung kurso nito ni Nicole. She's taking up architecture. Ang Mapua.
She's a smart baby girl.
Yeah. So, she deals with not just training, but a lot of plates.
Oh, sobrang hirap niya.
Yeah. It's hard. Alright. 17. Or 11 serving 17 here. A chip away. Susubukan ng EAC. Oh, Rica Blanca.
Wow. Rica Blanca with the stare down after that spike. Medyo ano eh, off character eh. But I love it all the same.
Bakit nga naman hindi? Look at that swing. It's a 7-point lead. Princess Manarang coming in for Mapua. Yeah, so I confirm it. 97, that was her first season. Mm. Talking about Nicole Ong, she won second best middle blocker that year. As a rookie, yeah. As a rookie. Did not win rookie of the year. It was Scott Santos who won it. As the Guzman scores.
Wow.
yung sinasabi sa akin ni Coach Aling na nagkausap kami. She has, or he has more depth now pagdating sa mga spiker niya compared to season 98.
And that's only a good thing, huh?
Yeah.
Para sa Mapua Lady Cardinals kasi ang lalim ng Arsenal.
Almazan. That one goes out, 22-11. Lumobo na ang Abante.
Yeah.
Ang Mapua.
9 points ahead for the Mapua Lady Cardinals.
Oh, yung mga pa-check-check, pinag-aralan mo ba yan kagabi? Yan ba inaral mo? Iiwas mo yung bola sa kamay ng blocker? Oh, eh ba't ginagawa niya? Ha? Baka gusto niyo mag-celebrate, kada nakakapuntos kayo, ng daan-daan. Hindi nakapuntos na kayo para kayo nasa Ponebre.
And that's frustrating for a coach. Yung ginagawa ng mga players mo sa court, yung hindi nyo pinractice.
Yeah. Alam mo kasi, malaking bagay din yung nabablock ka eh. Mentally. Because, alam mo, unconsciously, you start to iniiwas mo na yung bola.
Correct, correct.
Hinihinaan mo na yung palo mo. You know, dinadrop ball mo na instead of hitting it hard.
Naapektuhan ka na. Oo. At yung diskarte mo. We'll see if VAC can respond off the timeout. It is Perse sending out the free ball. Loot. Combination. Almazan down the line.
Yes, Almazan listening to her coach na bakit mo iiwasan? Bakit mo papadaanin sa kamay ng blockers? Eh, tinitraining mo, pinapalo mo eh.
Yung pinaractice niya. Almazan scoring, catching the corner pocket. 12-20. Oh. Manarang to Babiera. Picked up. Back row hit. Dug up as well by Garcia. Perse's approaches of speed this time. Tulak mula kay Razonable. De Guzman of the block for Hannah.
That was a good attack using her blockers. Talagang tumaan kay Razonable. You know, and that's confidence booster for De Guzman.
Ana De Guzman used to be part of the starting unit ni Coach Aying. Heavy hitter din yan. Oh, it drops in. No, pancake save by De Guzman.
Ooh. Yeah.
Sabi ni Coach Aying, dalawang kamay na patinig mo.
Because as much as possible, two hands is better than one. Lalo na pagdating sa control. Medyo nagmadali lang doon si Perses. You know, let's forgive her kasi it's her first year. And sure na ako, first year.
Ah, yan.
Rookie, yeah.
Una talaga yan. Pero to si Perses, of course, performing very well. Inserted earlier for Roxy De La Cruz. Di na lumabas kasi ang ganda yung pinapakita niya. Pero si Garcia commits the attack error. EAC gets the point back. 14, 13, 21. Still in the second.
It's 14,
21. Rhea Magalona. One of the middle blockers nitong EAC. Is on deck. Rebustes. Manarang. Taxet to De Guzman. Derecho kay umapas yun. Eto naman si Razonable. She scores. And she stares down her opponent. For just a little bit.
Yeah, for a little bit. Parang glance lang habang patakbo pa muna sa teammates.
Naiwan lang ng konti yung tingin. May sinilip lang.
Yeah. 15-21. And isa yun sa mga pinoint out ni Coach Rod na pag nakaka-point kayo, can you celebrate?
Oo. Ito. Pero ito, hindi sila mag-celebrate sa service error. That kills their momentum.
Yes.
Esteban comes in for the first time. For Mapua, this is Francesca Esteban.
Ooh, same name.
Oo nga, no?
Ako si Francesca.
Yeah, kailangan ipasok niya yung serve. Ayun, siya rin yung nagdig.
Wow. Sa good dig.
Garcia! Oh, a lot of heat! And that spike. 10 puntos na para kay Freyan Garcia.
Wow.
Walang sumabayan, no, Jessica?
Yes, and that was a good target. Wala na nga siyang blocker. Kasi isa yan sa mga nakakatulong sa floor defense. Uh-huh. It's a guide for the floor defense, yung blocking.
Wow! Wow, Hannah De Guzman with quick reflexes.
Regalo-regalo eh.
Yep.
And she just dumped it straight down. Parang dinunk niya talaga. That was smart as well. Kasi kung medyo pinahaba niya ng konti yung drop na yun, makukuha pa ng kalaban.
May nakadig dun. Set point, Mapua. Oy! Miscommunication. Pati tayo nagulat. Loot. Razonable! Sabi niya, not yet done.
Yeah. Razonable with a mas mahabang stare down.
A lingering look after this hit and point for Razonable.
Yes, sabi niya kasi, dalawa kayo dun, malaman na nakablock sa akin.
Oo nga. Dalawa yung blockers niya dun. 2v1. Ow! Service error. Been the story for years so far. And that's how we will end the second set. Mapua ahead, 2 sets to none. Versus EAC. We'll find out if they can end the match when we return in set number 3.
Ideal. Tapos, I also hosted a show called Upfront. It's a lifestyle show for athletes. And then, went on to do different gigs, non-sports gigs as well, on television. Currently on 24 Hours right now, Game Changer. We also feature athletes and different activities there. So, yun. And now, here with GMA Synergy with the NCAA and on Game On. Okay.
Yung pala yung ending
na. May I just say that as a friend and colleague of Martin, the thing I'm most proud about of this guy is when he hosts the red carpet of the GMA Gala. Para sa akin, you know, that's when you are at your best. You become the Ryan Seacrest of the Philippines when you're interviewing the likes of Ding Dong Dantes, the best in a Raver Cruz, Julianne San Jose, all of the stars. Mm-hmm. And you're the guy. You came from sports. You are interviewing these stars. Man.
16. Abante ang Mapua sa ating laban. 2 sets to none. A chance to close out the match when they do win set number 3. Pero set number 2 muna tayo dito. A more convincing, commanding win para sa Mapua din sa set na yan, Jessica.
Yes. That, for Mapua, it's going to be De Guzman.
Yeah.
Also, versus and Garcia getting all the points. Talagang team effort eh. Wala kang isingle out na tao eh. Everybody was helping sa defense, sa blocking, sa palo, of course. Yeah. And that's why they got the second set.
Mapua operating like a well-oiled machine.
Yes.
Nung set number 2 na yan, you mentioned a lot of players activated, including, you know, some of the players that came off the bench, katulad ni Hannah De Guzman. Pagkapasok pa lang, may impact na agad-agad para sa Lady Cardinals. And now we take a quick scan of the numbers dun sa naganap natin na set number 2. We'll do that in a bit. But we ended 25-16 there. A lot of points from that young lady, promising NCAA career ahead para kay Freyan Garcia. Only her first year, but she is in double figures once again on the side of Intramuros. Alright, pinasok na ni Coach Aying. So making her return in the match is Roxy De La Cruz with Tere Manalo. So si Berses upo muna alongside Babs Barbiera. Vanessa Basbas as the libero. And it's Trixie Gohol still for, or as the playmaker. Para naman dito sa EAC, nakita natin na may bright spot naman. Bukod kay Almazan, tumutulong na itong si Razonable.
Yes, that was a good change for Coach Rod.
Uh-huh.
Na pinasok niya si Razonable as an open spiker. Because matapang tong matapang. Si Razonable.
Ito na siya. Kakasabi lang natin. Ooh. Too strong. Pero too much power on that strike for Razonable.
Yeah. Pero makikita mo sa mukha nila, nobody's, you know, down dahil sa error na yon. Because the set is just starting and siya mismo, babawi ako.
Sharp serve unleashed. Razonable from the other side. Rica Blanca with a swing. Grabe yung palo ni Raisa Rica Blanca.
Ano mo, mahirap talagang basahin yung mga lefty eh.
Yung
iba yung trajectory ng bola nila, iba yung target nila. So, and she's using that to her advantage. Lalo na napakalaki ng gap sa blockers.
That's right. Itong si Rica Blanca, yung frame niya will, you know, is the indicator of how she spikes the ball. Then, lanky kasi yung frame niya. So, yung pectus niya, iba yung pitik niya, you know?
Yes. Medyo na mahaba lang talaga yung kanyang attack doon sa last na yun.
Kasi meron mga spiker chest na solid talaga yung approach eh. Yung talagang may brasong kasama.
Yeah.
Ito, parang latigo.
Yeah, it's a whip.
Like a whip, yeah. Ong. Umapas. Goal choosing Rica Blanca. Naandoon si Almazan. They go to Razonable. Of speed will be popped up. Ong. Denied. De La Cruz. Through the block. For Anet. That was Garcia.
Yeah. That was Garcia. Nagpalit sila eh. Mm.
Tignan natin ito. Oh. Frian making something happen in that sequence. That was a high set, high give. No problem for Garcia. Canto na sir. Villena with a lefty push. And Jaja will score.
Yeah. Medyo yung coverage.
Good discarte by Jaja Villena. So Razonable at the service line. She has shown promise ever since replacing Krija Reyes in that set number two. And as I say that, she commits the error.
Yeah. Alam mo, we should stop. We should stop. Yung binuburi natin yung mga players na magsa-surf pa lang.
Pagkatapos na lang, pag na-attempt na. Nicole Ong. Again. Is a wall today in front of the net. Almazan! Baba. 5-2 for Mapua.
Medyo straight to the net talaga yung palo niya. Hindi niya hinabaan. Because ang reminder lagi ng coaches, pag mas malayo mo sa net, it's better kung hindi ka naman super taas tumalon. No? Mas magandang mahaba yung tatargetin mo para pumasok, di ba? Because if it's short, ganun na mangyayari.
Kung tusok, katulad niyan, mula kay Almazan. At that time, she got the set in front of the net.
That was a good example na pag malapit sa net, now, pwede mo na siyang ibaba, you know? Pwede mo lang targetin down. Yeah.
So 3-5 Roxy De La Cruz on your screens again. Medyo inilabas siya kanina ni Coach Aying Esteban, and we saw that last season. Nilabas siya maaga ni Coach Aying. She was very emotional on the bench, pero pagbalik naman niya bumabawi siya.
Yeah. No, Coach Aying giving her a second chance here. Ooh.
That's an error on the side of EAC. So tumawid. Si Almazan. Let's see what happened here. Here's Kat. Approaching, was on the landing.
Yeah. Umasok yung paa pag-land. You know, it's a good thing na yung walang nangyaring injury, serious injury here.
Erica Blanca. Ex-service ace.
Wow.
Sabi niya, Chesa, anong injury? Ayan, a service ace for Raisa Rica Blanca.
Yeah, ginagalit niya siya eh.
Do not test.
That was a sharp
rookie.
Serve, yeah. Mm-hmm. That was a good serve from her. Oh my God, that was a strange delay, yeah.
Nakakuhunan na naman po ang EAC. They're trying to chip away. They're down by three. And again, they haven't gotten that solid start.
Yes.
Katulad ng set number one natin, Cheska, na nakikipagsabayan pa sila sa Mapua.
Yes, and they were the first one to 8 points.
That's right. That's true. Papunta sa technical timeout natin. That's on the line for Rica Blanca. First technical timeout is here. That is Mapua ahead by four. Pagbalik natin, it is going to be the report of Stephanie Benito.
People's lives. And with this show, I hope that we're able to do that even more.
Definitely.
Sabihin ko na nga, proud ako dun sa... Kasi ginawa niya sa akin kanina eh. Pinaka-proud ako. Hindi, dun sa...
Please be careful.
Ito na sa binanggit mo, sa mga binanggit mo. Nag-cover siya ng chess no? Challenge kay Antonion. With... Eugene.
Yeah, GM.
Pero ba-practice siya, di ba, ng online chess? Naglalaro.
Guys, we were doing that online kasi pandemic yun eh.
Nag-commentate siya ng virtual ah.
Rod Palmero is displeased by how his team's been acting or playing today. Kaya nga unang sabi ni Coach sa kupunan during timeout, eh bakit nagpapamigay kayo ng bola, o ng puntos rather. Pinaalalahanan daw niya ang koponan to not feel any pressure and to just focus on the system thought. Pero parang hindi daw nagde-deliver ang kanyang koponan. Kaya ito ang gusto niyang makita para sa set na ito for his team to deliver their system. Kung pressure naman at kumpiyansa ang problema ng Lady Generals sa panig naman ng Lady Cardinals, simple lang ang paalala ni Coach Aying Esteban sa team. It's to keep their composure and use it to their advantage. Pero huwag daw mag-relax at maging consistent lang sa mga pinapakita. Huling sabi pa ni Coach, sa team ay angki din na daw ang third set sa kanila na daw. Ito muna sa ngayon sa magkabilang panig. Balik sa inyo, Martin and Jessica.
Maraming salamat, Stephanie Benito. Kita mo yung contrast sa instructions sa coaches natin. It was Coach Rod who is looking for his player's composure. Para sa Mapua naman, Coach Aying, gustong ma-maintain itong kumpiyansa at composure mula sa side ng Mapua. And sabi ni Coach Rod sa akin kanina, itong mga players niya, you know, hinasa niya to talagang tinrain nila at dinevelop. And not a lot of them have experience of being in high-level volleyball games before they became varsity players here for EAC. So, this is encouraging for them. Nakikipagsabayan sila the best teams here in the league. Oof. Garcia with the attack error right there. So, dalawa na lang ang abante ng Mapua. Two straight from the technical timeout para sa EAC. The hall. Oh. Tinawid ni Lute. They go to Frian. For Jal with the dig. Razonable. Ball is still in play. Loot. Razonable. Oh, scores. Alex. Razonable.
Razonable off the hands of Roxy. You know, you can see Roxy here using one hand now.
Yeah. So.
Oh,
nice. Oh, hi. Unable to get to the ball properly to see Roxy De La Cruz, who continues to try and bring her game back. Oh, what a sharp serve. Better reception though from Roxy. Sinagot din ni Umapas. Almazan. Nandun si De La Cruz. De La Cruz from the back. Picked up. Loot. Netawid. Gohol. Oh! Manalo is denied. Rica Blanca for Jal. Ito si Razonable. Catching the corner pocket.
Sobrang sakto sa corner. Zone 5. That was a good target. Yung libero, medyo nag-iisip kung outside na ba yung palo. But that, you can see the libero of Mapua looking at the ball as it went inside.
4-0 run to equalize set number 3 para sa EAC. Garcia, that's too strong, and EAC will take the lead.
That was long.
Lady Generals in response to the technical timeout.
Okay, okay naman yung set. Okay yung offense. Ano nangyayari doon? Diba, bakit tumitigil na tayo? Hindi pa tapos. Hindi pa tayo nakakuha ng dalawang set pa lang nakakuha natin. Tsagain pa natin ng tsagain. Huwag kayong magmadali. Kung nadidepensa na, hindi walang problema. Didepensa rin tayo. Sinatsagaan nila, hindi tsagain din natin. Yun na lang ang labanan natin ngayon. Kung didepensa na, didepensa din natin.
Labanan ng tsagato.
Yes.
And Coach Aying Esteban, again, nire-remind lang yung kanya mga players dito.
Tama naman si Coach na kung yung kabilang team gagalaw ng maayos, didepensahan kayo, bablocking kayo, pare-pareho naman kayo nag-training, correct. Pare-pareho lang tayo nang nilalaro ng sport. So gawin nyo din.
Sabayan nyo.
Yes.
Good response. That ends the 5-0 run of EAC. Rica Blanca with the put down.
From the back row. Good target from her. And, you know, yung sequence na yun, ang dapat re-receive na doon, libero.
Libero na. Okay. Deadly talaga si Rica Blanca pag ganun yung buwelo niya. No? Uy! Napasok ni Razonable. Garcia. Loot to the back row! Masyado malakas para kay Almazan. So Mapua with two quick ones.
May gigil yung palo ni Almazan and she's gonna be replaced.
Entering for the first time, itong si Orendain. Ano-ano kaya niya si Pat Orendain, di ba?
I was thinking that as well. Magkamag-anak kaya sila?
Mahira yung ganyang pangalan eh. Sa volleyball pa.
Yes.
Regalo kaya? Hindi. Tatawid ni Ong. Resonable. This is a pass to Garcia. Good defense by Orendain. Resonable. Sobra ulit. And it's those transition plays, those broken plays.
Yung energy, not energy eh, pero yung power level. You know, instead of just hitting it as hard as you can, kailangan mo mag-target.
Wasn't the right target for Umabas as that was went straight to the net.
Yes, another error for the Lady Generals. Na, ito na naman, dahil sa three errors na yan, 3 points na ang lamang sa kanila ng Lady Cardinals.
Yung 5-0 kanina ng EAC, sinagot ng 4-0 nitong Mapua. And that's a sharp serve by Kare Manalo. Razonable off the block. And of course.
Yeah. That was a better hit from her. Alam mo na ba, pati ko, no? Pag ito ng blocker, medyo ma-outside yung palo. So, talagang pinapactor yun niya sa palo niya is always meron siyang blocker.
Gusto niya meron siyang kasabay, ano?
Yes. Parang dadaan sa kamay niya na.
Alam mo si Razonable, pag tinanong natin siya, sa Java yung stand-down pass. We see a service ace from Rhea Pagalona. This has been rare for EAC in this match.
Especially since no middle blocker pa rin. Middle blocker pa rin to, no? Yeah. But, you know, we have a misconception. Para sa akin, misconception yun na ang middle blocker is medyo mahina mag-serve. Because in today's time, hindi na yan totoo.
Gagaling na rin.
That was a check.
Check ball. So it's Rhea Garcia. Able to score on the check.
Yeah, pero as you can see sa kanyang mukha, parang she was not happy about that.
She wasn't satisfied with her approach. Pag tinanong natin si Razonable mamaya, kung matatanong natin, ba, sa Java yung konting stare down, sasabihin niya, hindi po, ganun lang ako lumanding talaga. Garcia. This is a better attempt for her.
Maybe she's more satisfied with this attack.
And with a single block in front of her. Cash that one in para dito kay Frian Garcia. Loot. Razonable. Nandun si De La Cruz.
Ooh, no blocker for Rica Blanca.
Yeah.
and wide open.
Yeah, that's very dangerous. Makikita mo, baka matama. You know, the difficult thing about that, or yung pinaka sakit doon kapag walang blocker, is baka mamukhaan naman yung teammate mo.
Yeah. Ang lakas ng palo doon, Rica Blanca.
Sabi niya, regalo-regalo, wala talagang blocker.
Oh, good save by Basbas. Rica Blanca, bumalik! Pero off the block for Rica Blanca. That's a point for them. Second technical timeout. This is still in favor of the Lady Cardinals.
Okay, so now you know us. Feeling ko naman yung mga sports fans na nakikinig sa atin, you know, may isa na silang game na napanood na siguro lang na nandun tayo. Tayo yung nagko-cover ng game, or at least we're somehow part of the coverage. All right, so Game On is finally a podcast. We're very happy about this.
Yep.
You know, we will cover, kung dun po sa Game On TV version, syempre, it's all about the NCAA. Happy
16-11 dito po sa third set natin. Chance ng Mapua para kunin ang kanilang ikalawang panalo sa season 99. Raisa Rica Blanca with 12 points across her name, powering that through two blockers.
Yes, and there's two players with 12 points dito na sa kapunan ng Mapua Lady Cardinals. Ayan po si Frien, and of course, si
Raisa Rica Blanca. First-year players.
Oh, wow. Diba? Yeah.
Both rookies.
Rookies talaga ang bumubuhay ngayon sa Lady Cardinals.
That's right. Oh, wow! Alex Razonable.
Yeah. Medyo nagbabalikan sila ng stare down ni Rica Blanca eh.
Alam mo, mas matalim pa yung tingin niya kaysa doon sa atake niya.
Yeah. Pero that was, alam mo yung mga moments na talaga na overpower mo kasi yung kalaban mo eh.
Yeah.
You know, your hands are both in the net, pero yung bola pumasok sa kanya.
That's right.
You were able to get it across. Kaya talagang...
Oh, ito ulit siya.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh. 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 And the reaction from Nicole Ong.
That was Garcia.
Oh, that was Garcia. Hold on.
With the stare down.
Let's see. Oh, yeah. It was Freyan who got it.
There you go. Pero medyo sweet pa din. Parang glance lang eh.
Silip lang. Yeah. Yung kay Nicole Ong pala, gumanon lang siya. Hindi pala it was more of a celebration. Yeah. Okay, Nats versus back in the game. Uy! Makas. 13-17.
Out for versus.
This is the first man we've seen from Nats versus. And it's off the serve setter. Just trying to keep it light. Tony Sabersas, Alex Razonable. This time, kanina nag-error to sa serve. 6 points off the bench. Ito, pinasok niya. De La Cruz, checked. Rica Blanca explodes for that down the line finish.
Pero nakita niya na she has a space for down the line hit, and that's what she does.
Such a deadly swing. Grabe, bigyan mo siya ng magandang height sa set. Oh man. Villana. Middle attack will not work. De La Cruz! Oh, using the hands of her blockers.
That was out.
Oh, that was outside rather. Oh. Dumaan pa lang sa mabas.
Dumaan sa net.
So 14-18.
Yeah, Roxanne still struggling here. Roxy.
Oo nga, no? Nawala sa momentum kanina si Roxy De La Cruz. Unable to get it back. Gallardes coming in to serve.
Serve.
Yeah, better service from her. Rica Blanca. Rica Blanca. Goodbye. Grabe to. This is a promise. amazing duo wow. for Mapua.
And you can see, wala talaga na sa ibabaw siya ng blockers niya. No touch whatsoever from the block.
Yeah. No touch because she was above the blockers.
Yes.
So much potential. Itong si Raisa Rica Blanca. Omapas. That
wow.
was deflected by De La Cruz. But Omapas scores nonetheless.
Yung mga ganong check ball. Usually for the sweeper na yun eh. Sweeper is open spiker. There you go. That was supposed to be for Versus. Pero hinabol na din naman ng libero. So she's... Kala niya kukunin ang ate niya eh.
Yeah. Di inabutan. 15. Serving 19. Jump serve from Omapas. Bouncing off the net. Hannah De Guzman. It's up and alive. Almazan. Apuele yun. Manarang. To De La Cruz. The windup was there.
No
the attempt was too long.
No check. That was out once again. For Roxy.
Yeah. 60-19. EAC again. Knocking on the door. We'll see though if they can continue it.
Ooh.
Oh.
Service goes out.
It's not just, you know, the service errors, but the timing of these errors is what's hurting them.
Exactly. Ngayon, because of that error, nasa 20s na ang Lady Cardinals.
Oh, combination play. Been a while since huling in-execute ng EAC.
Yeah. That was on the first set pa. So they should really do more of these combination plays because ito yung mga nakakapag-confuse sa blockers.
And in these moments, si George Lute kailangan ng pumorsyento dito. Of course, their best option on offense is Almazan. I said that right after the serve.
Yeah, right after.
Right after. Okay, so I didn't jinx anything. Coach Rod, pahingan natin.
In favor of the Home University.
Ibigay ng pagkakataon na makausad kayo na magkaroon kayo ng momentum. Sino po puputol sa momentum? Galing nyo. Nag-insayo ba kayo niyan? Ganyan? Ha? I-grab nyo naman. Pag-aralan nyo naman, i-grab yung momentum. Mamadali. Ano ba yun? Wala silang kahirap-hirap. Mananalo sila na walang kahirap-hirap sa inyo.
That's true.
May sinasabi si Jaja sa'yo, ayaw mo siyang pakinggan. Pakinggan mo siya. May sinabi siya sa'yo, ayaw mo pagkatiwalaan yung tao.
Point raised by Coach Rod. Katulad ng sinabi din natin kanina, sila rin lang yung pumuputol sa momentum nila with these errors.
Yes. That's why yung service kasi, sabi, laging pinapaalala ng coaches yan eh. Hmm. You have 8 seconds.
Okay.
Huwag mong madaliin.
Yeah. That's right. Lalo na pag, ayun, sabi niya rin nga, matuto kayong kumuha ng momentum.
Yes. Kasi usually, ang titigil ng momentum, or nagtatry tumigil ng momentum, is yung coach ng kalaban.
Yeah, that's
because
right.
They want to break it, di ba? Kapag tuloy-tuloy ka na nagsiserve, mayroon biglang magta-time out.
Time out nila. Correct, correct.
But for them, sila na yung pumipigil ng momentum nila. Yung minapadali yung serve, minapadali yung receive.
And it makes it a lot easier for their opponents
yes.
to take sets dito. 22-17 in favor of Mapua. 3 points away from a big bounce back performance are the Lady Cardinals. Lute to Razonable. 23-17. Manalo. Back as a middle blocker. Full time na for Coach Aying. Perses. Perses. Goes long.
Attack goes out.
chance to mount a comeback could be the final one of the match.
Yes.
If
medyo nakakakaba mag-serve pag mga gantong moments. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Magalona!
So that was an ace for Magalona!
Her second one in this match.
What nerves daw.
Again, that's a middle blocker, Jessica.
Yes. And alam mo, pinakita mo, pinanood lang nung receivers eh.
Yeah.
That's why the coaches then laging nare-remind ah, na sundan mo yung bola
correct,
hanggat
correct.
Di pa lumalabas yan, di ka sure na lalagpas yan sa court.
Kunin mo.
Kunin mo.
Oo.
Sundan mo.
Hey, Guzman. Magalona. Omabas!
Oh,
that's too strong. And it is match point. Mapua Lady Cardinals. 24-19.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Mapua.
Yes. Now serving
trying to get back on the winning track. And they're on the brink. Like out.
Yeah.
Not one of those. So EAC is giving a breather.
Medyo binadali niya rin yung serve niya. Diretso sa net.
But no room for errors if you're EAC.
Wow. Ito yung nerve-wracking talaga na service. Match point ang kalaban and you're the one to serve.
And it comes from their setter, George Lutz. Tanda nung serve. Finisher denied.
Ooh. Oh, that was a lift.
So, EAC saves 2 match points. They're still in this.
That was a lift, yeah.
Which rod on your screens? Loot. Manarang, can they end this? No, not yet. Oh! Oh, no! Wow! EAC unable to get to the ball. Mapua will take the win! Look at the sequence, Jessica. That was the up. Loot to Mama Zanet. Oh.
Yeah, that was nobody for the follow-up for the third ball. There were 3 people there though.
Yeah.
Tatlong tao yung malapit sa bola, but nobody took the initiative to get the ball across sa kalaban nila. And that's gonna be heartbreaking for the Lady Generals and for Coach Rod. We'll see na talaga sa game na, we'll see sa training nila. Papahirapan sila sa training for sure.
Oo, abangan na nila yan.
Yes.
Pero Mapua with a bounce back performance here. They're back to their winning ways. Let's listen to their school hymn.
Hear a song from the hearts of the wielders of compass and transient chains. Of a mighty name and his glory. Away from your doors, I'll be born.
once again.
All right. At the conclusion of this one, Mapua taking it in 3 sets. Let's go to a quick break. Pagbalik po natin, kakausapin natin si Coach Aying Esteban and a couple of players from Mapua's side. You guys are watching NCAA Season 99 on GTV.
Mga kapuso, let's take a quick look back at the early goings of our brand new NCAA volleyball tournament here in the first edition of our Week in Review. On opening day last Sunday, the Benilde Lady Blazers began their quest for a three-peat on a high note as they dominated EAC 25-15, 25-14, 25-23. Graduating middle blocker Mitch Gamit led the way for the Taft Avenue-based squad with 10 markers. In the match that followed, Perpetual flexed their muscles against JRU, winning 25-14, 25-14, 25-21. Reigning league MVP Mary Rose Dapol top scored for the Lady Altas with 16 points. On Tuesday, Mapua outclassed San Sebastian with a 25-20, 25-23, 25-18 victory. Sophomore Super Roxy De La Cruz exploded for 18 points to lead the Lady Cardinals. After that, LPU needed 4 sets to dispatch San Beda 25-17, 13-25, 25-15, 25-21. Joanne Duguna was the player of the match as she finished with a team-high 17 points. Nung Miyerkules naman, winalis ng JRU ang EAC 25-20, 25-20, 25-23. Pinangunahan ni Kyla Hasareno ang atako ng Lady Bombers sa kanyang 13 puntos. Pagkatapos nun, matagumpay ang naging pagbabalik ni Coach Oliver Almadro sa NCAA sa pagkapanalo ng Letran laban sa Arellano 16-25, 25-17, 25-17, 25-17. Si Coach O ay alumnus ng Letran at naging player pati na rin assistant coach ng kanyang yumaong mentor na si Ness Pamilar. And that, mga kapuso, were the...
Sa pagtatapos ng laban ng Mapua contra EAC, it is the Mapua Lady Cardinals bouncing back here. Big time sweeping EAC 25-19, 25-16, 25-21. Martin Javier with Jessica Rakraking. And kasama na natin, as promised, ang winning head coach. Wala sa Mapua Lady Cardinals, Coach Aying Esteban. Coach, congratulations.
Thank you, thank you.
Congrats, Coach.
Thank you.
Grabe ka na, Coach. Grabe ka na. De. Congratulations on your second win of the season. Alam kong talagang gusto ninyo mag-bounce back. Lalong-lalo na a tough loss against, you know, an opponent na familiar kayo, yung Perpetual. Talk about the preparation going to this match. Alam kong naging hard yung naging training nyo this past week.
Yes, sobrang bigat niya kasi magkasunod yung talo namin. Then, puro straight sets pa yung nangyayari sa amin. Pero, balik pa rin kami sa square one kung ano yung sistema na gusto namin mangyari. Binalikan lang ulit lahat namin yung basic na dapat namin gawin. Then, sinasabi ko nga sa mga players ko na once na ginamit ka dyan, samantalahin nyo na dahil minsan lang kayo ilalagay doon sa loob ng coach. Yeah. So, gawin nyo na kung ang dapat nyo gawin talaga.
Coach, na-stress ka ba sa laban to? Oh, hindi naman. Relax lang. Yeah, may mga moments na nagpapakita ka ng frustration eh.
Yes, kasi minsan yung mga easy ball na dapat pang-score na namin, nawawala pa sa amin. Lalo na yung mga chances na easy ball na lang yung bumabalik, naka-i-score pa lang kalaban. So, doon ako nawawala ng
composure
dahil imbis na ipupuntos na lang namin, nawawala pa.
Okay, bago ipasa kay Cheska dito, kinausap kita last game na ang hinahanap po sa mga players mo, yung talagang panapo, showing you the composure and yung character nila sa court. Eto ba, sa panalong to, unti-unti mo na yung nakikita mula sa mga manlalaro mo?
Yes, sinasabi ko nga sa kanila, yung laking kulang talaga natin is yung maturity natin doon sa loob ng game. Kaya pagdating sa endgame, nawawala tayo. So, hanggang sa training namin, yung scrimmage talagang pinakita ko talaga, ito dapat mangyari, ito dapat yung nangyayari pagdating sa dulo. So, talagang nireview namin yung pangdulo namin talaga na.
Oh, yun, nakatapos kayo ngayon.
Just, Coach, yes. Ano yung pinaka-pinag-focusan nyo sa training talaga? Blockings ba yan? Attack? or yung service receive niyo?
Actually, lahat kasi dinadaanan namin sa training namin. Pero ang pagdating kasi sa babae kasi kung sino yung mas maraming matibay na depensa, siya yung mananalo.
Okay.
Hindi naman ganoon kabilis yung bola, hindi naman. So pag ikaw ay dumipensa at nanalo ka, ibig sabihin yung depensa mo nagpanalo, hindi yung block mo, hindi yung offense mo.
Yes, exactly. Tama yun, coach. And ngayon naman, sa mga attackers mo, puro sila rookies. Ano yung mga reminders na binibigay mo dun sa girls?
Binibigyan ko lang sila ng compose na talagang kung ano yung kaya nila hanggang sa limit na kaya nila. Ilaro nila yung gusto nilang ilaro. So sabi ko, huwag silang masawa, huwag silang matakot mapagod dahil marami naman pamalit. Pag napagod ka, papalit na. So binibigyan ko lang lagi sila ng motivation na para gumalaw sila ng maayos.
Okay. Coach, yung Mapua for the past 3 seasons, parang nagiging pugad yan ng magagaling na rookies. Naalala natin, season 97, si Nicole Ong yung nag-emerge. Last year, meron kang Roxy De La Cruz at marami pang first-year players. This season, parang yung 1-2 combo mo, Garcia at Rica Blanca. Anong meron ba tanggaling yung mag-develop ng mga young players?
Siyempre, sa training, repetition, ulit namin sa kanila. Then siyempre, sinasabi ko nga sa'yo, sa recruitment namin, minsan lang kami magkaroon ng players na gusto magmapuha, na gusto mag-kumuha ng
course, gusto mag-aral
sa mapuha. So, pag may mga ganun players, tinatsaga namin turuan, tinatsaga namin talaga na matuto kung anong gusto namin mangyari.
Okay, coach. Eto, before we let you greet your loved ones here, kasi kanina nakita natin si De La Cruz nag-expression ng emotion nung nilabas mo siya sa court, di ba? So, this is not the first time it's happened. Nangyari din to last season. Ano yung nire-remind mo sa kanya kapag ka nangyayari yun? Alam natin kasi passionate siya, gusto niya nasa court siya at makatulong sa team niya. Ano yung mga words mo sa kanya ng sitwasyon na yun?
Ang sinasabi ko lang naman sa kanya, kaya ako siya nilalabas kasi hinahanap ko kasi niya yung makal. Then, pag pinalabas ko siya, gusto ko makita niya kung ano yung hinahanap ko na maitutulong niya dun sa team. So, hindi ko naman siya nilalabas dahil sa personal or what. Ang gusto ko lang is maglaro ng maayos. Kung sino yung gumana dun sa loob ng court, siya yung gagamitin ko. Kung ikaw maganda yung laro mo, di ikaw yung may iwan dun sa loob ng court.
Tama. Unbiased si coach. Yeah.
Correct. Base lang talaga sa performance. Yes. Siyempre. Ang pinalit mo sa kanya kanina, si Nads Berces, na napansin ko, coach, against Perpetual, medyo nag-struggle si Nads. Ito, ang ganda ng mga palo niya. Ano yung potential nitong batang ito, coach?
Kasi itong batang to, eager na eager talaga maglaro eh. Alam, gustong-gusto niya talaga maglaro.
Coach, kahit wala masyadong emotion, ganun lang siya. Laro lang.
Deadpan lang siya, coach.
Ganun lang siya. Simple lang siya. Pag maglalaro sa training namin, tahimik lang siya, pero gagawa siya ng maayos. Hindi siya masyadong nagsasalita, pero magpe-perform siya ng maayos. Yun ang gusto ko sa kanya.
Coach, kumpiyansa ka ba? Kasi siyempre, yung ibang teams natin, ang mga, kumbaga, porsyentuhan spikers nila, mga veterano na sa liga, yung mga tried and tested na. Ikaw this season, ang mukhang nagiging tema, mga first-year players, rookies. Ito, kumpiyansa ka ba? Kasi siyempre, you made it to the Final Four last season. May pressure na mag-Final Four ulit. Pero ikaw, gaano kataas yung kumpiyansa mo? At tiwala mo dun sa dalawa mong wing spikers, kahit rookie sila. Nadadalid nila kayo dun ulit sa posisyon na yun.
Siyempre, yung tiwala ko, siyempre, 100% na binibigay ko sa kanila dahil talagang kaya ko sila tinaya dyan sa court na yan dahil sila talaga yung magpe-perform na maganda. Kaya lagi ko silang nire-remind, sinasabi ko na hindi ko kayo ilalagay dyan na hindi nyo kaya.
Oo. Huli na lang, coach, kasi napansin ko rin from the previous match, si Gohol, medyo nahihirapan siya mag-set kay Rica Blanca. Ngayon, mukhang naayos nyo na yan at mas maganda na yung naging connection kanina. Ito ba pinag-insayuhan nyo?
Yun nga, mahirap. Sa season natin yun, sobrang iksi ng preparation. So, kung ano lang yung kailangan namin, i-correct nung sa team namin, yun na lang yung nangyayari. Yung review-review ng mga kalaban namin, bihira na lang mangyayari yun. So, kung ano man yung mga mali na nangyayari doon sa loob ng court namin, yun na lang ang parang finishing na lang namin yung mga galawan namin.
Fine-tuning na lang pala nangyayari.
Correct. Pero partida, straight sets pa rin.
Yes.
Napanalo, coach, against the EAC Lady Generals. Okay, looking ahead, coach, 2-2 in the season. Obviously, you want a much better start from your team. Pero ito na, yun nangyari so far in season 99. Ano pa yung abangan natin sa Mapua, especially in the coming games?
So, sa akin, hopefully, yung pagkapanalo namin ito, sana madala namin hanggang sa dulo. So, yung kumpiyansa ng players ko, yung skills na pinapakita nila, sana mas mag-improve pa para umabot kami agad sa dulo.
Okay, speaking of improvement, coach, sa lahat ng mga players mo today, sino yung pwede mong i-single out na i-comment mo na nagulat ka? Ay, ganda ng pinakita mo ngayong araw na to.
Siyempre, si Rica Blanca.
Si Rica Blanca.
Kasi
nandito siya katabi natin.
Oo, sabi niya, bias na kayo. Pero, totoo lang, in terms of sa skills, sa block niya, yeah, sa offense niya, sa defense niya. So, na-complete niya yung sa mga skills na kailangan namin yung araw na.
Okay, coach. Oras na para batiin mo lahat ng mga nanonood sa inyo ngayon. Kung marami nakasuporta sa Mapua Volleyball.
Yes, Mapua community, thank you very much sa mga support na binibigay nyo sa amin. Then, binabati ko nga pala yung mga parents ko sa Marikina, si Nanay Presi at si Tatay Enteng. So, salamat sa support na binibigay nyo sa Mapua. Sana tuloy-tuloy lang po. Sana huwag mo kayong magsawa. Thank you.
Coach, hindi sila magsasawa. Ayan, lalo ang ganda niyang pinapakita niyo dito. Coach, ayun Esteban, winning head coach today. Maraming salamat.
Congratulations again, coach.
Grabbing their second win of the season. But as promised, meron pa tayong mga kakausapin na players mula sa Mapua Lady Cardinals. Let's turn you over to Stephanie Benito with Rian Garcia. Go ahead, Stephanie.
Yes, Martin, thank you so much. Kasama ko nga ngayon ang isa sa mga very promising rookies from Mapua Lady Cardinals, Rian Garcia. Rian, first off, congratulations. Grabe, after two heartbreaking losses, finally, you guys are back to winning this game or the game today. How does it feel?
Sobrang happy po kami kasi nabawi na namin yung mga pagkakamali namin sa past games namin. And nakuha namin yung gusto namin na manalo nga ngayon.
Ayun eh. Tanong ko lang sa'yo, Fian, sobrang condition mo. Simula pa lang ng season hanggang sa laro mo ngayon, sobrang condition. What drives you to play so well every game?
Siguro nakikinig lang talaga ako sa mga sinasabi sa akin ni na coach, sa mga tinuturo sa akin ni na coach. Tapos tinatry ko yung best ko every training para madali na siya every game.
Ayun, feeling ko isa na nga rin sa nag-drive sa'yo, yung sinabi mo sa akin kanina na tiwala na binigay sa'yo ni Coach Aying, pati ng teammates mo. Alam mo, coming into this game, aware kayo na yung EAC Lady Generals is a very hungry opponent, a very hungry competitor kasi nga they're trying to win their first game ever. So, paano niyo sila pinagandaan to make sure that you guys are gonna get the bacon today?
Well, binaligan namin yung mga past two games namin na talo kami. Inayos namin yung mga pagkakamali namin. And yun nga, gutom din kami na manalo. So, ginawa namin yung best naming lahat para manalo this game.
And grabe, napakita nyo naman yung 100% best nyo in today's game. Siguro huling katanungan ko na lang sa'yo, Frian. What more can we expect from the rookie, Frian Garcia, as well as the team sa mga susunod pa na mga laro?
Siguro, we'll always try our best na ipakita sa inyo kung ano talaga yung laro namin, kung ano yung kaya namin gawin sa court na may reach namin yung goal ng bawat isa.
Ayun, ngayon naman, Frian, bibigyan kita ng pagkakataon to greet, to thank your fans and the Mapua community. Go ahead.
Thank you po sa mga nanonood, sa mga Mapua community, sa mommy ko na nanonood, and sa family ko dyan, sa Lipa, lolo ko, and yung dog ko na si Felky. Hello!
Hi, Felky! Congratulations ulit, Frian. Balik sa inyo, Martin and Cheska.
Ayan, maraming salamat, Frian Garcia. Another solid performance. Sorry, makikihay na rin tayo sa pet niya, si Felky. Okay. Congratulations, pero yung katandem niya dito sa laban natin. And in the season so far, our player of the match is this young lady right here, Raisa Rica Blanca in double figures. The lefty power hitter ni Coach Aying Esteban. Raisa, congratulations.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Oh, grabe ka naman, Raisa. Only your first year in the NCAA, pero ganto na agad yung mga performances mo so far in the season. Okay, let's talk about your first year. These are your first few games. Bakit ganto agad yung performances mo? Ano yung sekreto mo? How was your preparation? Lalong-lalo na nabanggit mo sa akin off-cam na nag-residency year ka pa sa Mapua. Habang preparation yon going into season 99.
Ayun nga po, nung nag-residency po kasi ako, parang gigil na rin po. Gusto ko na rin pong maglaro. Kaso nga lang po, hindi pa po pwede kasi kailangan pa po ng one year na maghintay po. So ngayon pong chance ko na po na makapaglaro po. Binibigay ko po talaga yung best ko.
Ayan, napakawala na nga itong si Rica Blanca.
16 points. At saka pinag-uusapan natin yung approach mo, yung swing nyo. I asked earlier si Coach Aying, kasi against Perpetual, napanood ko yun, medyo nagka-problema kayo ng connection ni Trixie pagdating sa set. Ikaw ba, personally, pinagtrabahuhan niyo yung connection na yung dalawa ng mga ensayo niya?
Nung ano po, last 2 days po, yung nag-training po kami, winner out po talaga namin ni, sabi po kasi sa akin ni Coach Aying, nauna daw po ako. Hindi daw po ako makatiming kasi isa-set pa lang daw po yung bola. Nakapasok na daw po ako. So, wali na off-timing po ako. So, ang ginawa po namin nung 2 days preparation po, yun lang po talaga yung win-workout sa akin and pati din po yung blockings and defense po. Pero nag-focus po kami dun po sa approach po na yun.
Sabi mo kay Coach Aying, kaya nga nauna kasi isang taong ka naghintay eh. Palong-palo ka na.
Na-excite na siya.
Na-excite na.
Palong-palo na talaga.
Okay. Cheska.
I just wanna ask, ano pang personal growth or goal mo for this season? Ano pang gusto mong ma-achieve? Meron ka pang career high na gustong makuha?
Personally naman po, ang gusto ko lang po makapag-contribute po talaga sa team. Pero meron po kaming goal as a team po na makabalik po sa Final Four din po. Kasi hindi po kami nakaabot ng podium finish since pang fourth lang po kami last season. So gusto po namin i-improve po yung standing namin para na rin po sa Mapo community.
Yes, that's a good answer. Alam mo, team player pala tong si Ryza. Yeah. Wala siyang personal growth or personal goal. Ang gusto niya lang, makatulong sa team niya.
Oo. Pero tinanong natin yan kay Coach Aying kanina kasi siyempre, first year player. Mm-hmm. Apparently, aligned kayo dun sa goal ninyo na makarating kayo ulit sa Final Four. Pero ikaw, so far, kamusta yung pag-a-adjust mo with the competition dito sa NCAA? Kasi alam ko, may mga liga ka nang nasalihan, you've been part of different teams, lalo nung high school. Ang ganda ng programa na pinanggalingan po nito from Adamson. So, ang ganda nun, how are you adjusting to the competition here sa NCAA?
Dito naman po sa NCAA po. Bale, yung mga teams din po, mga players din po, ang lalakas din po. So, mas nag-adjust pa po ako na mas tiwayan pa po kasi hindi ko rin po in-expect na ano po, na ayun nga po, nung first year ko po, ngayon pong first year ko po, magiging ano po ako, first six po. So, dun sa team po lang po namin, ang dami ko na pong kalaban na malalakas. Kaya sa sarili ko po, gusto ko po talaga, pinag-ano ko po talaga itong pwesto na to.
Pinaglaban mo talaga.
Oo, pinaglaban ko po talaga kasi nagulat po talaga ako kasi pagdating ko po sa Mapua, sobrang lalakas din po ng mga opposite Spikers. Tapos dito rin po sa league po na to, grabe din po yung mga Spikers. Hindi ko nga po nabablock ng maayos. Kasi nga po, lalakas din po ng mga palo po nila.
So talagang ano, hindi mo in-expect na magsisimula ka as a rookie. Ha? Hindi ko po, talaga, kahit ano mga off-season tournaments ba? Off the bench ka o parte ka na ng starting lineup?
Kasi nung unang league po, verse 6 din po ako. Kaso parang na-overwhelm po siguro ako. Tapos, ayun po, parang medyo bumaba po yung laro. Tapos, yung teammate ko po, siya po yung Sidney Guzman, siya po yung naging verse 6 po namin. Tapos, parang si Coach Aying po, pinush lang po ako ng pinush. Na sabi niya po sa akin palagi na kailangan po ako ng team. So, bali, naging wake-up call nga po yun sa akin para po makabalik po sa laro ko po ngayon.
Ito, Ryza, pakiramdam mo, kailangan kong tanongin. Anong kurso mo sa Mapua ngayon?
Civil Engineering.
Civil Engineering. Diba, sinasabay yung pagbabarsity, pagiging student-athlete. Okay, paano mo sinasabay yun? Ang busy ng course na yan. 5 years ba yan? Hindi, mas maigsi sa Mapua kasi mas marami kayong terms, ano?
Opo.
Pero, paano mo pinagsasabay yan? Ang hirap nun.
Nung enrollment pa lang po namin, pinaiwas po agad ni Coach yung yung schedule po ng oras. So, bale, bawal po kami kumuha ng subjects na pang umaga po kasi umaga po talaga yung training namin.
Ganun talaga yun.
Mabalance naman po.
Yes, ganun talaga yun. Siyempre naman, ba't ka kukuha ng mga subjects na magko-coincide sa training mo, di ba? Tama naman.
Pero grabe yung dedication na yun kasi alam natin, engineering, it's a very demanding course. Okay, nahihirapan ka ba? Pero, as a student-athlete, hirap ka ba ngayon? O talagang determinado ka na patunayan yung sarili mo as a volleyball player?
Yung sa student-athlete po, dati ko po kasing pangarap yung maging engineer po. Pero ang dami ko na pong first years, yun ko lang po siya nakuha. Kasi parang pinagbawalan po ako dati kasi nga po sa laro. Tapos ayun po, nung nakuha ko na po, gusto ko pong i-push kasi gusto ko rin naman po maglaro at the same time gusto ko pong makatapos.
Yes. And anong nagiging itsura ng schedule mo on a day-to-day basis?
Oh, gising ka?
Ano po, gising po tapos 6 a.m. po kasi yung training namin. Pag ang hanggang 11 po siya, pagkatayin po ng 11 after training, mag-wash up na po and then po diretso na po sa school.
Oh.
Ay, sa classes.
I remember the days.
Grabe yan. Yeah. Ano? Ibang klase yung schedule punong-puno, jam-packed every day. Alam mo, sa ganda ng laro mo, binibigyan ka na ng mga EAC men's team natin ang bola dito. Munti ka nang ipagdig, ha? Okay, hindi. Pero, Raisa, congratulations. Ikaw naman, as a teammate today, as a rookie, big win para sa inyo to. Nakuha niya ulit yung kumpiyansa. Sino i-comment mo na teammate na ang ganda ng performance bukod sa'yo ngayong araw na to?
Si Ate Chok. Si ano, you know? Trixie Gold.
Si Ate, oh.
Tama yeah, naman. Tama.
Higher badge ba si Trixie?
Dapat kabatch ko po sa
ano. Okay, so hindi ate, si Trixie. Yeah. Kaya kasi maganda yung connection nyo.
Opo, yes. Kasi ayun nga po, winworkout po namin talaga yun nung past 2 days po. And ayun po, kasi nag-connect po kaming dalawa ngayon. Parang nagbunga po yung pinaginapan po namin nung last 2 days.
Okay. Yes. Siyempre, parang naman daw siya magiging player of the game kung hindi maganda yung asas sa kanya ni Gold. Oh,
okay, curious ako kasi siyempre, rookie ka dito sa liga. Kumbaga, 2 games ago, nag 20 points ka. Tapos pagkatapos against Perpetual, medyo nahirapan ka dumiskarte against sa team na yan. Kung first year player ka, paano mo pinoprocess yung mga ganung laro? Na may mga down na games ka na katulad nun?
Sa akin naman po kasi, kapag, ayun nga po, parang career high po, tapos bigla kong bumaba. Feeling ko po na pressure lang din po ako sa sarili ko na kailangan ko ulit makagawa ng maayos. So, nag-end up po siya na bumaba po yung laro ko po that time. Pero yung game po namin against Perpetual, ginawa ko po ulit siya ang motivation para po makabawi po ulit. Kasi, ayun nga po, 2 lose streaks na po kami. Mm-hmm. Tapos, ayun, para makabawi po talaga. Hindi lang po ako, pati rin po yung team.
Ngayong araw, bawing-bawi naman, 16 points in just 3 sets for Raisa Ricablanca. Alright, pagkakataon mo na siyempreng batiin yung mga nanonood sa'yo ngayon. Family, friends, loved ones watching you right now. Raisa, ito na, pagkakataon mo.
Wait lang, gusto ko lang po mag-thank you sa...
Sige, pwede rin yun.
Habang,
sama mo na dyan lahat. Oh.
Gusto ko lang po mag-thank you sa family ko na nanonood po all the way from Batangas po. Isa rin po sila sa motivation ko para galingan po ngayong game po na to. And binabati ko rin po yung family ko sa dyan po sa Santa Mesa, si mama ko, and yung family ko po sa Batangas, sila lola ko, si mami, and yung mga pinsan ko po. Ayun lang po. Maraming salamat din po sa Mapua community.
Ayan, nandito pala yung family ni Raisa na nanood today. Ito ba yung sinilip mo kanina dito sa likod?
Sa kabila.
Nasa kabila sila.
Nasa
kabilang side. Okay. San sa Batangas?
Kalatagan, Batangas.
Maganda mga beach doon.
Oo. Ganda. Okay. Tsaka medyo malayo-layo yung biyahe yan. Worth it naman yung dinrive nila papunta dito para panoorin ka dahil panalo at ikaw pa ang player of the game. Congratulations, Raisa.
Thank you po.
Okay. Ayan po, Raisa Ricablanca, 16 points today for the Mapua Lady Cardinals. Yung player na kinomend niya kanina, alam ko kinomend niya yon kasi nakikinig eh. Nandito, makausap natin susunod. Trixie Gohol kasama ni Stephanie Benito. Stephanie, go ahead.
Yes, Martin, kasama ko ngayon ang idol nito ni Raisa Ricablanca na si Trixie Gohol na third season na naglalaro para sa Mapua Cardinals. Trixie, first off, congratulations. By the way, birthday mo pala bukas. Opo. Advance happy birthday.
Thank you po.
Sobrang meaningful ng pagkapanalo nito para sa inyo. Siguro ang tanong ko lang sa iyo, after 2 losses, finally nagkaroon ulit kayo ng victory. Meron ba mga pregame na paalala sa inyo itong si Coach Ayin kaya na-drive kayo to win? And what does this victory mean for the team?
Siguro po, ang sinabi lang sa amin ni Coach Ayin ngayon, sa laro namin ngayon is no pressure. Galawin lang namin kung ano yung ginagalaw namin, lalo na sa training. Ayun po.
Ayun. And as someone who's been playing for 3 years na for Mapua Cardinals, ngayong araw na ito, pinakita mo yung galing mo, yung skills na meron ka as a player. Anong meron? Anong meron today? Anong motivation mo? Bakit maganda yung pinakita mong laro?
Siyempre po, gusto ko pong bumawi and gusto din bumawi ng team namin kasi nga po, nakadalawang talo na po kami magkasunod. So this game, sabi namin, babawi na kami and sana magtuloy-tuloy na yung panalo namin.
Ayun, at nakuha nyo nga yung victory nyo after losses para sa araw na ito. Ito, curious lang ako kasi kanina natanong ko si Coach Aying Esteban. Tapos, kung paano ba kayo nagpre-prepare? Ang sabi niya sa akin, hindi kayo nag-scouting against EAC. Hindi rin kayo nanood ng mga previous games whatsoever nitong kalaban nyo today. In a player's perspective, paano kayo naghanda against for today?
Pinanood din po namin yung ano, yung game namin nung mga last game po na nang natalo din po kami. Pinag-aral namin kung saan kami nagkamali, kung saan kami kulang. Ayun po, inisa-isa po namin and nag-reflect din kami isa-isa.
Ayun nga. So, talagang mas nag-focus kayo sa individual, sa kung paano kayo naglalaro, kung paano nyo nilalaro yung sistema.
Kasi po, kasi po nung last game po, ang dami naming mga unforced errors na hindi naman po, yun po. Kaya pinag-aralan talaga namin.
Oh, and nakita naman natin kung paano nyo talaga pinakita yung best nyo para sa araw na ito. As someone who played last year, who went to the semifinals, and as someone who's fighting for a semifinal spot naman para sa season 99, anong mas challenging para sa'yo?
So, tingin ko po ngayon, kasi mas lumakas lahat ng team. Lahat, hindi mo ma-dictate kung sino yung magpa-final four kasi nga lahat nag-aangatan talaga.
Ito po, and very unpredictable, no? Ito, bago kita pabatiin, Trixie, sobrang curious lang ako kasi kanina, itong si Raisa, parang nadulas. Ang tawag sa'yo, Ate Chox? Ate Chox, tama ba?
Ate Chox.
Bakit Ate Chox?
Kasi po, Bochok po yun. Kasi nga, mataba.
Parang hindi naman ah.
Daddy ko lang po kasi talaga yung may tawag sa akin noon. And narinig po ng mga friends ko. So ayun po, kumalat na po. Pati po yung mga napuntaan kong coaches, Chok na rin po tawag sa akin.
Nasanay na
natawagin. Nasanay na po sila.
Ayun. So okay, Chok. Nandiyan kita ng pagkakataon ngayon na batiin yung fans. The Mapua community, go ahead.
Hello po, binabati ko po yung Mapua community and thank you po sa pag-support sa amin and sana patuloy niyo pa po kaming suportahan sa mga upcoming games namin. Binabati ko rin po yung family ko, Gohol family, Sivine family and Milyado family po.
Ayun. So once again, congratulations Trixie. Congratulations to the Mapua Lady Cardinals. Back to you, Martin and Cheska.
Thank you so much, Stephanie. Trixie Gohol, of course, our primary setter today para sa Mapua Lady Cardinals. Again, setting up her teammates very well, activating a ton of players to get them going offensively. Ito po ang ating final, 25-19, 25-16, 25-21. A win for Mapua. Let's go to a quick break. When we return, we'll check out the highlights and the numbers of this match.
What was the most shocking transfer to you?
Yung nakita mo last season na pwede ko itong kakampi. Pagkakampi ko ito, champion kami.
Who would win a one-on-one game between you and Jake?
Oh! Bakit ba lumilipat ang mga players? Maraming factor yan. Yan yung susubukan natin, pag-usapan at himayin kasama ng ating special guest for today. He is the reigning rookie MVP of NCAA basketball, Mr. Clint Escamis, on this episode of Game On the Podcast.
How's the
bigla mo yun.
How's it going, sports fans? I'm Anton Rojas. Welcome to Game On, the podcast, the first sports podcast of GMA, brought to you by GMA Regional TV and Synergy and GMA Digilab.
We are also seen and heard on GMA News and GMA Sports PH on Facebook and YouTube. Of course, listen to us at Apple, Spotify, and Google Podcast. I am Coach Hammer Martin Antonio.
And my name is Martin Javier. Technically, guys, this is our first episode of the podcast. Kasi yung unang-una natin, that was more of an introduction.
This is still our coverage of the NCAA Season 99 Women's Volleyball Tournament. We'll check out the highlights of this match. Sisimulan natin syempre sa set number 1. It was won by the Lady Cardinals 25-19 in this particular set. EAC pumapalag pa to against Mapua. Cheska.
Yes, maganda-ganda pa yung ginagalaw ng both teams dito with the Lady Generals. Nauna pa sila sa 8 points in this set.
Again, bumitaw po sila bandang dulo na. It was the Lady Cardinals who started to take over. and also took advantage of the timely errors nitong EAC. Dahil EAC, mapa-atake at mapa-unforced error nangyari dun sa crucial stretch na yun. And of course, we go to set number 2, and this was a different story. A more dominating Mapua was seen in this particular set. 25-16 was the ending, Cheska. At nakuha na nila yung laro nila dito. EAC just finding no answers for the Lady Cardinals in that set.
That's right. And the EAC Lady Generals, medyo bumababa na yung kanilang kumpiyansa during the set. You know, they don't celebrate as much. Yeah. They don't talk as much. And sila mismo dinadoubt na nila yung sarili nila.
That's right. Dito nakaraming puntos. Itong si Freyan Garcia, who fight a lot of points. Talagang kinargahan niya yung mga atake niya. Went through the EAC blockers most of the time. At ito, Hannah De Guzman entering the match at the latter part of that set, providing some finishing touches. And going into set number 3, Mapua was just rolling. Pero pumalag ang EAC dito, Cheska. Nabuhayan ng konti.
Yes, that's right. They got their momentum during their endgame. But ito na naman, sila din yung pumutol ng kanilang momentum during that stretch dun sa final stretch ng set na ito, no? Sila yung nag-service error and then, again, yung last point for this match was walang nag-over ng bola.
Okay. It was a couple of errors that ended our match ultimately. Again, EAC Lady General shooting themselves in the foot. You see the frustration mula dito kay Coach Rod Palmero. Ang constant reminders niya para sa kanyang mga players, hindi naman yan yung nilalaro nyo. Yan yung ini-ensayo ninyo. Okay, lone bright spot for EAC. Actually, they have 2. Pero si Almazan yung pinaka-consistent para sa kanila. At ito yung mga finishing touches natin dyan. Final few points. And Mapua is able to take their second win of the season. And now we take a look at our final numbers here, Jess.
Yes, as you can see, talagang pagdating sa attacks, the Lady Cardinals dominated the Lady Generals. But pagdating din sa blocks, same story. Sa digs, mas marami rin, of course, na depensahan ang Lady Cardinals. Sa aces naman, medyo isang point lang ang katalo nila. But ito, medyo nakakagulat.
Nakagulat, ano?
Both opponent or both teams, talagang tayo sila sa 26 errors each ang binigay nila sa kanilang mga kalaban.
That's right. 26 errors, tambla. So, ito nagkatalo talaga sa atake at sa blocks. Again, we have to commend the underrated blocking nito Mapua Lady Cardinals led by Nicole Ong, who was just a wall in this match. Impenetrable wall. Dahil lahat ng attackers itong EAC sinasabayan niya at nahihirapan makalusot.
Yes, and dahil sa pagbablock niyang ito, itong nakaka-commit din ng errors ang Lady General kasi iniiwasan na nila si Nicole Ong pagdating sa block.
So, kumbaga hirap na nga dumiskarte yung mga spikers ng EAC. Ayan, di ba?
That nireceive ko na lang.
Ano ang sinasabi nila sa'yo? Sabi nila, Cheska, bumalik ka na sa paglalaro. Ayan o. Ikaw na yung sinusundan ng bola dito, minamagnet ka na. Hindi. Pero, I was going back. Iba na nga yung hindi na masyado makadiskarte itong spikers ng EAC. Tinagdagan pa ni Nicole Ong yung kanila mga problema.
Yes, that's correct. And pagdating naman, pagka-over nila ng bola, madalas na po nadedepensahan sila ng Lady Cardinals. And the Lady Cardinals knows how to turn this into a point. Okay. Nandyan si Rica Blanca. Andyan din si De Guzman. Andyan si si Freyan.
Kasi Freyan Garcia.
I always think about her name kasi yung basa natin kanina, diba, is Freyan. And then I heard that it's Freyan. So she's always in my mind.
Wow. Oh, ganun ka-effective yung at saka impactful yung performance ni Garcia.
Yes.
Natatak na siya sa isip ni Cheska.
And Garcia, mas naalala ko yung Freyan na pangalan.
Yeah.
So si Freyan, you know, pagkatapos niya pumalo ng heavy spike, and then she's gonna smile so sweetly. Kaya sabi ko, contrast yung paglalaro niya sa kanyang personality.
That's right. Malaking contrast din mula dun sa ways din ng EAC spikers na medyo may konting angas pagkatapos ng spike. Itong Mapua Lady Cardinals, they just go back to their celebration at yun, they just celebrate their point.
Reasonable ang nagsimula ng mga...
Alex, talagang so much spice on the court, especially off her attacks.
Okay. No, nakakatulong din yan sa kanya eh. Oh. Kasi kapag ka nag-aangas ka, alam mo yun, nabuboost mo yung confidence mo, especially kung hindi na kayo nagsiselebrate, parang medyo down na lahat.
Oh.
Kahit ikaw na lang mismo, you know? Kasi ako as a teammate, kapag ka merong nag-aangas sa teammate ko, ako din natutuwa. Oh, natatawa din ako.
Nakakahaway.
Yes.
Yan.
Oh. Para ikaw, oh my God, sige. Ako nga din, natutuwa kayong lahat eh, as a team, collectively. Kaya maganda rin yung ginagawa niya na yun.
That's right. That's Alex Reasonable of EAC. Obviously, scored a bunch of points off the bench, but not enough for the Lady Generals today. Ngayon naman, tutungo tayo sa highlights ng ating men's game. Earlier, very early in the morning, I think this started 7 a.m.
Wow.
Laban ng LPU Pirates. And of course, the Perpetual Altas, our defending champions. It was outright domination from the start mula dito sa ating defending champs. Tignan natin yung numbers dito. A lot of players contributing to the cause right away for them. And let's check out some of the highlights here. LPU, they're a much more complete team this year compared to a season ago, but again, they still lack some tools. Dito naman sa side ng Perpetual, that's the reigning MVP, Louis Ramirez. Very hard to stop. Most efficient spiker in the men's division just by his elevation and power. Pero may pambawi ng konti ang LPU doon. Jun Edang had 4 points in that set for the Pirates. Lots of options para dito sa Altas. That was Casey Andrade, who also converted 4 points. Ibang klase, no? Eto naman si Louis Ramirez.
Exciting sa mga gantong matches. Talagang yung paluan nila, ang lala eh.
That's right.
Yung bola talagang kung mag-bounce, kala mo aabot na sa ceiling.
Yung final natin doon, 25-16 in favor of the Perpetual Altas, set number 2. It was pretty much the same as Perpetual jumped off to an early lead as well, led in this set by Louis Ramirez, who scored 8 points in set number 2. Did not do much in the first set, pero bumawi siya agad-agad. This is Jefferson Marapok with the down-the-line hit. He scored 5 points in that set 2 alone para sa LPU. It's been rare. Pero nakakakuha sila ng mga gantong conversion puntos mula kay Jun Edang, who was up to 8 points as well. But Louis Ramirez was just too much. Come on!
Ramirez. Talagang parang kahit may blocker siya, dinideadman niya na lang eh.
Alam mo, pag pumapalo si Louis, naaawa ako sa ball eh.
Yeah.
Diba? Just...
Alam mo yung mga photos ng ganyan, yung paghawak, yung pag-touch sa bola, di ba parang naka-curve na yung bola? Inward.
Parang hinit.
So, sobrang lakas ng ng palo eh.
Nade-deform na.
Yeah.
Oo. And set number 3 was pretty much the same. This was the most dominating set for Perpetual, ending at 25-15. Lots of players as well contributing para sa kanila, led by Louis Ramirez, who had 4 in this set. And Casey Andrade, one of their middles, also 4 points. Jun Edang tried his best to keep his team in the match. Scored 16 points in total. Nagdagdag pa ng 4 puntos sa set na to. But ultimately, defending champions, again, mahirap. Still on a roll here. In season 99, I believe they're still perfect in terms of their record. Still very unstoppable and still the team to beat in the men's division.
And that's yun yung pride ng pagiging defending champion eh. You know, kailangan all your games, gagalingan mo.
That's right. Ito yung team standings natin sa men's division. Perpetual, I mentioned, 4-0 start. Now, a team that will be in action next, itong EAC Generals can duplicate that up against the Mapua Cardinals, who was a very tough team. 0-3 right now. This is unusual for a Mapua team who almost made it to the Final 4 last year. So, alam mong may gigil din tong Mapua.
Oo, oh, hinahanap pa nila yung groove, hinahanap pa nila yung first win. So, lahat yan aggressive, lahat yan paglalaban talaga yung bola. So this is going to be an exciting match.
That's right. You see the standings right here in right there rather in the men's division. San Sebastian, I think, is the biggest surprise so far, mm-hmm. especially with the season, with the year that they had last year. They were shorthanded pretty much in most games. Pero dito, maganda yung bounce back nila. Okay, let's go to a quick break. We'll talk some more when we return dito po sa NCAA Season 99.
I want to add the face of the NCAA. I dare say.
Last mga James Yap nung vibe ni Clint.
Bro,
steady lang. Steady lang.
Yeah, it had to be Clint, no? Yeah. Because of Clint's story coming back to the NCAA. This is where he came from in high school. And now we're starting this new platform. So Clint, maraming salamat for the time. It's great to see you again. Last time we saw you, well, last time Martin and I saw you, you were in the crowd, but we're not going to mention that. Let's just mention game 3
why
the finals.
Okay.
Parang doon ka agad pupunta. O Clint, kamusta yung off-season mo?
You know, after nung finals, syempre, enjoy muna. Ano, take a breather. Went back to my home province, Davao. And yun. Drink some beers and spend time with my family.
Nagpanalay ka ba sa Davao?
Hindi. Okay. Nagpanalay. Sabi ko, ano, Alinis. Basketball hate.
Pupunta tayo sa may UNAV. Okay, para silipin ang home court ng EAC Lady Generals.
Hello mga ka-NCAA, this is Stephanie Benito at nandito tayo ngayon sa Emilio Aguinaldo College and this is NCAA Home Court. Oh! Alam kong excited ang ating mga manonood para malaman kung paano pinagandaan ng Lady Generals ang season na ito. Pakikwento naman sa amin.
Mas better kami than last season. Makikita nyo na mas pag-iigihan namin na mag-strive pa more pataas kasi nga nasa bottom kami. So mas ipupush namin yung team namin pataas.
This season, pinaghandaan po namin yung efficiency po namin. Yun yung pina-work po talaga namin ngayon at still working on it pa din po. Yung confidence po namin, yun yung win-work namin this month.
Laging sinasabi ni Coach sa training, dapat lagi kaming consistent sa lahat ng galaw namin. And dapat di kami mapapagod, dapat laging palaban lagi sa kahit anong games na haharapin namin.
Excited ang ating mga Lady Generals fans na malaman kung ano yung mga off-season, pre-season preparations ng team para pagandaan ang season 99.
Winorkout namin sa training yung mga lapses namin last season para mas makapagbigay kami ng mas magandang laro this coming season 99. Unang-una yung efficiency namin. Yun yung pinakamahirap sa team, kahit sino. Yan ang lagi namin winoworkout kasi sa bagong mga bata, sa mga bagong players, siyempre yung system napakahirap kunin and we work out talaga sa system, sa efficiency ng system namin.
Ito pa kayo, medyo personal na tanong naman. Para sa season naman na ito, meron ka bang mga specific challenges na naramdaman?
Meron po, tulad ng pagka-homesick, ganyan. Siyempre natural po yun, tsaka pagod sa ensayo, pero kasama po yung mga teammates, kumbaga, na-overcome namin ng magkakasama, nagtutulungan kami, ganyan.
So, para naman sa Season 99, sino naman ang team to beat ng EAC Lady Generals?
Siyempre, yung champion team.
Benild po.
Benild po talaga.
So, sino yung mga X-factor o yung ina-expect nyo na mag-step up at bakit?
This season, si Catherine Almasan pa rin. Tsaka si Jaja Belien. Yan ang mga makikita natin na mag-excel this season.
Mas pinaghandaan po namin talaga para po sa akin, mentally po. Kasi yung physical po kasi kaya na kasi nagte-training po kami before, last season, ganyan, parang andito na po talaga. So yung mentally po kasi talaga, once na masira po ito, bibigay po lahat.
Abangan po nila yung mas maging matapang na Lady Generals and palaban po ngayon season 99. Alam din naman po namin na halos lahat ng team nagpe-prepare, so pinaghahandaan din po namin lahat ng teams ngayon.
Sa EAC community, please support us, the EAC Lady Generals, and sa mga friends and families na nandiyan, tuloy-tuloy lang po ang pagsuporta. Kahit na medyo nag-struggle pa, pupunta rin tayo na magiging maganda rin at the end.
Ano naman kaya ang susunod na NCAA school na ating bibisitahin? Muli, this is Stephanie Benito and this is NCAA Home Court.
Home court of the EAC Lady Generals sa UN Avenue. But that's how they prepared in this season. Bukas po, balik tayo dito sa Philoil Eco Oil Center in San Juan City, April 21st. On a Sunday, we offer a doubleheader for you guys that will start at 12 noon. San Sebastian, naghahanap pa rin ang kanilang unang panalo against a streaking Arellano team. Afterwards, these two teams have been on a collision course since the season started. Both undefeated, Letran versus Benilde happening afterwards.
4-0, pareho.
Yeah, ang masasabi mo.
That's gonna be a good game. Alam mo, excited ako mapanood ko anong magiging laro ng Letran. Because, you know, we know what to expect na pagdating sa lalaruin ng Lady Blazers. And gusto ko lang, alam mo, I'm gonna watch that at home, ah.
Yeah.
Napanoorin ko na lang yung game nila. Because I wanna see how Letran is going to move tomorrow.
That's right. On behalf of the entire team, my partner Cheska Rakrakin, our courtside reporter Stephanie Benito, our director Derek Abit Ramos, our game producer Manny Gabutina, Mark Morados, our panel director Stephen Cruz, Pacasenya, Roy Tulio, Romel Narciso. This is Martin Javier saying thank you for tuning in. We had two games today. First, a five-setter, a win for LPU versus Perpetual. Next game natin, kani-kanina lamang nanalo ang Mapua Lady Cardinals via a sweep over the EAC Lady Generals. This has been your NCAA Season 99 on GTV. We'll see you guys tomorrow for another round of action dito po sa NCAA.